You guys are basically just waiting for someone to come and get you. It's nightfall now, and yeah, they said they come and get you at nightfall, and you guys would to do, the ritual and everything. You guys want to do anything before that happens, or?
I would like to visit said market.
There's no market. That it's just in the picture. There's no actual market.
So there's no shops or anything, right?
Right.
Do we know that Senor Little Donger is here searching for Sansa?
No.
You don't know who I am yet. Stop metagaming.
The market has been reduced.
You have no idea that Milby's character even exists right now.
Hey, can we go to Spur and Shine?
Where is that?
Spur and Shine.
It's right next to where the market used to be.
I mean, I would like to have my armor cleaned since last time we spoke, I had pissed my pants.
That's true, you did. Are you talking about Spur and Shine that doesn't exist anymore?
All right, how about the
Nope.
sheriff's office?
Nope. You know what? Just here.
I do want to write.
Now float in the nether.
There are two bins.
So, all right. So you guys are just chilling. You guys want to talk about anything?
Yeah. Is
or
it?
Do?
It's
Like,
night.
What do you got?
It's night, right?
It's nighttime.
How long have we been sitting here?
All day, pretty much.
Just all day since we got here.
Yeah.
All right. Nazan goes out back to be alone.
Okay. So old Nazan's going out back.
He's having a hard time.
He's processing everything.
Yeah, he's yeah. You could say that.
All right. Well, at this point, the druid's gonna walk back into the room. Justin, are you gonna stay outside for a while?
Yeah, kind of have to.
All right, so I need you to leave the channel. I'll tell you when you come back.
All right. Sitting by myself outside meditating.
Hey, weirdo, we're leaving. Wake up.
You have to touch me, Brian.
Nope.
I'm meditating. See, does that? Gotta throw something at me, Brian.
I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna poke you with a stick.
Okay.
I've poked Nazan with a stick to get him out of his weird trance, and we're leaving.
Right. I gave him a sharp glance, and came back.
All right. So how you doing over there, Justin?
Badly. But okay. I'm all right for right now.
All right. All right. Here, I'm gonna put this picture in here for you guys to give you all.
Oh my God!
Yay! It's happy.
All right. So, you guys.
Paintbrush.
It's pretty good. I like it. It's got fireworks. It's very.
It's very Bob Ross.
God damn it!
These are happy fireworks.
All right, so you guys go out to the bonfire. You notice that there are a ton of people there. There's, you know, the leader, which you've seen before, and sitting to his left is another giant man who, you know, is basically wearing like a bear pelt. It's like a cape kind of deal, and he's just fucking huge. Like, he's kind of sitting down, so you kind of can't gauge exactly how huge he is, but, I mean, his arms look like tree trunks.
I imagine it looks like Mary's dad.
At the bottom of his pants.
Yeah. Yeah. His dick's a little peeking through, you know. Really don't.
It looks like Merida's dad from Brave.
Yeah, exactly. Alright, so.
One dead eye.
So you guys get out there, and the leader walks up to you guys and he says, "Welcome. You are about to experience something that most people never get to experience. It's something that we have figured out. And since you all were so nice to bring our beloved spirit mender back to us, we're going to ask you all to participate in this with us in order to maybe find out a little bit more about the necromancer that you guys were trying to kill, and also to figure out what she was seeing in there, because she said what she saw was very important to our cause. So, without further ado, I will introduce the leadership of the Grey Rock. He says, "My name is Tratus. I was like one of the first that was stricken by the Indigard." He says, "To my left is General Grievous. He's here to advise me and help me out in any way he can. And the spirit mender you saved, her name is Shala. She does any shamanistic rituals or any delving into the spirit world that we need done in order to further our intel and help our cause. So are you guys totally cool with this communion thing? You guys down like a clown?"
I got a question. How many swords does this General Grievous have?
He has 17, actually, all over him. He can we'll say that he has 4. It's too many that you need, but I mean, it's an homage, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do there.
I don't know what he does with all those.
Alright, so Shala comes up and she explains that, you know, the communion will help draw out the most suppressed memories of her, and is generally used to find out information regarding traumatic experience to bring the information to the surface. She also explains that the communion is a spiritual journey that's influenced by eating a specific root that has been brewed in a specific concoction. To show the imbiber events that others have seen or transpired in the past. The way the potion works is whoever drinks it in the vicinity, their minds are kind of linked, and magically you kind of experience everything that they went through with them. So you're basically going to get a first-hand experience as to what happened in her mind at the time. So we're ready to do this. Anything else before we get going on this?
And Zahn volunteers for that particular thing. I mean,
he's like, "Where's the soup?"
He's probably the best choice for it out amongst the group.
Yeah.
Is this root that they use called is it called Shmeyote?
No.
Shmiawask.
It's called Laphsoralysis Dream. It's a LCD for short.
Does it come in an ejectable or strictly?
No. It's you drink it right out of the bowl that they're gonna put it in for you guys.
All right, I'm ready, man.
She says all of you all can partake. She goes over. She basically picks up a bowl that's already prepared, and she lays it down in front of all of you all and in front of her, Traitus, and Grievous. So all of you all can get in on this sweet honeydew action.
Sweet honeydew action player.
So I got to start a song here.
Wait a minute. I got a question about this.
Okay, what's up?
Everybody in the vicinity, minds are linked.
Yeah,
I don't want to be linked with crazy man.
It's gonna
Justin
be.
Maybe Justin should sit out.
It's gonna be a problem. Is it a two-way or a one-way thing?
It's a one-way thing. Like, you can only see what she's experiencing. It's not like all of you all can see into each other's minds. Okay,
it might be fine then.
Yeah, I think you'll be all right.
Okay.
If you're good for this, you should be an expert in this at this point.
Yeah, I just. For the benefit of everyone already, around me, I don't want.
I've already finished my drug soup.
All right,
can I have some more drug soup, please?
Get ready. We're going on a journey. Oh God! No! Oh God! No! 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 This is all around you guys. I'm freaking out a little bit. No! Oh, God! Oh, God!
My hands are so big!
I don't know what to do with my hands, guys.
Snozzberries taste like snozzberries.
I've drank some shit in my life, but this is some shit.
I let out a hearty burp.
I certainly know what Carl's Jr. is.
All right,
this is
so
mainly what Checkers is.
So you guys are traveling through the spirit world pretty hardcore here. Macedon's helping us out. So the first thing that you all see is, of course, Deadfinger basically laughing maniacally. You know, just through her eyes as she's basically injecting these horrible memories into her head. You guys are also seeing this as well, but you know, you guys are pretty tough, so it doesn't really affect you all in any negative way. But the one thing that you kind of start to see is kind of clears up a little bit, and you start seeing memories of, you know, Deadfinger back when he was part of the Endergaard, Holy Guard. He's got a man on the ground, and the man is bound in shackles and a collar. And it looks to be some type of apparatus to restrain him. It's not holding him to the ground or the wall or anything. He's just standing there in front of Deadfinger. And Deadfinger is using his force to kind of stop him from being able to move or do anything like that. Also, the man who is standing there, his eyes are like glowing blue, and it, you know, it seems like he could be pretty powerful, but something's kind of holding him back from it.
He's definitely about to put his finger up his ass.
So is this like a three-eyed raven moment here, where we're just like looking around? Hold the door!
God damn it. Alright. You guys have so you guys are basically in the scene. You can't influence anything. You can't hurt anybody. You can't.
Can we look around and see where we're at, basically? Like in the world?
Sure. Yeah. I mean, you're in like a. It looks what to be like a giant prison cell. I mean, there's like stone wall all around you. There's like a bed in the corner that's made out of like hay and like a burlap sack, and you know, and then there's like the cell door that's currently closed and locked behind you all.
Is Deadfinger wearing like an Endergaard uniform?
Yes. Yeah, his clothing indicates that he is very much a part of Endergaard. It looks kind of like Brian's armor.
Hey, Dwarf, do you know where they are?
That's what I was about to get into here. So, Kev, can I roll a history?
Sure.
What was that? Press 3.
A 1.
Well,
a 3. Can yeah, Brian doesn't know shit.
Brian, he's just too whacked out of his mind on Shmayoti.
Yeah. So,
Shmayoti.
Brian looks around. He doesn't. He has no idea like where this is taking place at.
Can I roll a history?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's right.
All right, Matt can also not tell what's Damn. Going on or where they're at. By also making more checks.
Yeah, I'll fucking do a history.
What the hell?
You guys are focusing on bigger picture here. You guys need to focus on the smaller picture. But all right.
Do I recognize that blue-eyed guy?
No, not at all. You have no
Is
idea.
He wearing anything recognizable?
Nope, cloth pants. That's it. Covering his donger. Everything else, he doesn't have a shirt on. He doesn't have like anything covering up his bottom half of his legs or his head. He's pretty beaten up. If you look in his skin, there's like cracks in his skin. And it's like not like he's got like an infection or a skin disease or something. It's like
I have psoriasis.
Cracks. Like all over his body. You rolled a 19 on the history check. You still don't. You have no idea where you are.
Okay.
It's just a cell.
What about Arcana? See what he's doing to him.
Sure. Okay. So, I mean, you can absolutely tell that he's trying to manipulate him to get into his brain. He's trying to basically get him to spill his secrets, if you will. He's doing the same kind of torture shit he was doing to Shala.
Mm-hmm.
That's what's going on. So you kind of notice that's going on. You hear the man kind of... he's not really, like, screaming, but he's saying, you know, like, I'm not sure what you're trying to do. You know, this doesn't do anything to me. Like, it doesn't hurt me at all. You're just wasting your time. Like, he keeps saying things like this to Deadfinger. And whatever Deadfinger's doing appears to not really affect the guy at all. But he can't move or do anything like that, so he's kind of got him held down, but... Whatever torture thing he's trying to do, it doesn't really do anything to him.
So, does this skin thing... do we recognize that in any way? Like, is it regionalism or disease or anything like that?
No. No, it just doesn't look like anything you guys have ever seen before. One thing to take note of before we kind of move on is old Deadfinger here. You just have to realize that he, you know, he's a very powerful person. You guys can actually feel what he's doing through the astral connection that's connecting you to the spirit realm. So you know Deadfinger's pretty powerful when you can kind of feel something in the past ripping through space-time to the future into the present. All right, so you guys witnessed that scene. Is that you guys good with that? You guys got anything else you want to do or say? Or all right. So now, getting into you know, that memory goes away. So getting into the next memory here. She looked really deep into Deadfinger's mind, and she saw something that was buried very deep. You guys are basically standing in front of this stone wall, and the only thing you see in front of you is the stone wall. Like, to the right and the back of you is kind of like an infinite nothingness. So it's just like, you know, you're just getting the stone wall in front of you, and that's it. Inside of, or on the stone wall, kind of inside of it, there's like, it looks to be like 8 holes in like a circle. And in the middle of the holes, there's a sword that is kind of plunged into the wall. So, like, there's nothing you all can do with the sword right now, but you just notice it's in there, and there's kind of 8 holes around it to look like maybe something fits in those holes.
Can I do, like, an insight to see if that, like, is a symbol or represents anything?
I've got stone cutting, I can double my history roll on that.
All right, well, we'll let Matt go first, since he's got kind of knowledge of the... of the holiness. I guess you do too, but okay. For right now, I'll say that you take a really good note of the formation and what that looks like and everything, but you don't really know what's going on, but you can recall it pretty easily. But you don't really know where it's from or what it means. You've also never really seen anything like this before either. So, Ryan. Okie dokie. It's pretty insane. Let's see, I gotta give you something. Alright, so
freaking bone here.
Alright, so you kinda like notice the stonework around the sword and the holes in it is extremely well done. It's just like you've never seen craftsmanship like it when it comes to stone. The other thing you notice is that the sword is sealed in the wall and, you know, looks like you can't pull it out. You can't even fucking move it. It's as if it was a part of the wall. So whoever made this knew what they were doing.
Is there anything special about the sword?
Is it the You don't really notice anything about the sword at all. No, I mean, it's just sitting in the wall. It just looks like a normal, like, great sword. It's a pretty big sword.
Well, those are keyholes.
So, you don't want to do anything with the holes other than stick your dicks in them?
No, I was thinking we're one person short of having...
I'm sorry, what happened? Chris's family died. And a horrible imploder accident. What'd you say?
Oh, I said we're one person short of being able to all put our dicks in the hole.
That's true. Need that. Damn you, Alex.
Let's not get someone a tentacle.
I mean, with him. Yeah, we could, yeah.
That's another thing, too. Is
we can't interact we'll that, with the plane, right?
Right.
Well, I mean, after we find it, though.
That's another thing, too, is Alex's character wouldn't wake up at the house, so he's still sleeping.
Too much to drink.
Yeah, he's having a bad time.
I accidentally touched him in my sleep. I'm really sorry, guys.
Right. All right. So that's pretty much it for the communion. Do you guys have any other questions about the stuff, or are we all good here?
I had to step away briefly. I know that we saw the dude getting interrogated in the prison cell, and then we fast-forwarded somewhere else, and I came back just in time to hear that there was something going on with the sword. I missed that first part.
Okay, so basically the party saw a sword that was stuck in the wall, and there's like 8 places around the sword in a circle. And the sword looks like it's melded like a part of the wall.
Okay.
That's pretty much it. Brian also noticed that the stonework on it is fantastic. Someone really knew what they were doing when they created this I don't even know what you call it, monument, if you will.
Okay.
All right. So now we're coming back to life. Coming back. You guys gotta come now. You guys gotta come back now. Is that a landmine?
Oh, it's rook mine.
Alright. I hate you so much. All right, so you guys are back now. After you guys come back out of it, you notice you guys are kind of like shaken up a little bit because that was like a first timer thing for you. But Tratus, Shala, and Grievous are sitting outside, and they're cool with it. Tratus looks over at you all, and he's just like, first time, huh? It's pretty wild.
I need a drink.
We can't drink any more of that.
No.
So I have a question. Mm-hmm. This stuff we drank, what does it do to allow it to do what it does?
It's basically, okay, so the way it works is the druid basically creates like a spell or a ritual, and the root allows the ritual. Okay, so the ritual is to do what happened, right? So you go and you go see everything. The root was cut from the same tree. So, you know, you all are basically connected through the root.
And it allows us to see into the mind of whoever is
I get that, but I'm trying to determine from a character point of view how this would affect him.
Okay. Yeah, so, I mean,
is it tamper with you, like, with your mental state enough to make it so you could see this thing, right? So you'd have to lose concentration on what you were doing to see what you were doing.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay. Well, that's not good.
Yeah, so you guys...
Zahn's having it. He's going to take a while to recover from that.
You guys were in La La Land for about 30 to 40 minutes.
Yeah, so whenever he comes back out of it, he's, you know, out of breath, and he's not doing so hot.
Okay. So, all right, so here's the thing. Tratus tells you all, you know, what was going on in there is Deadfinger was trying to extract memories or information or just something from the boy or the man, the young man, whatever you like. And he's extremely powerful, obviously, if Deadfinger could do anything to him mentally. So something is going on. Now, the Endeguard have captured this man. They have beaten this man, and they've destroyed this man's life. So Tratus is thinking that if we go and help him, we're 100% going to get him on our side, right? So Shala tells you all that while she was in Deadfinger's captivity, he talked about a prison that was near Endeguard by the name of Destron. And she was saying that, you know, that's got to be where he is. Like, there's no way that isn't where he is because... You know, they've got heightened security around there now. I mean, they got fucking scout parties going out there, you know, every day, checking all that shit out, figuring out what's going on. And basically, they've 100% seen that, you know, they're starting to ramp up security. They're starting to get everything going with this. And it could be a place where Deadfinger is, too. You know, I mean, he started there. He was in the Endeguard. He might be there again.
So then... He's still with Endeguard?
I mean, it didn't look like it when you all went to fight him.
And the Endeguard tried to send us to kill him to begin with.
So, yeah. They're trying to get rid of us.
He's gone a little bit rogue on him.
Yeah. So, I mean, all of that is speculation. You have no idea what's true or not. But, you know, Tratus is basically telling you all that, I mean, he was there before trying to get information out of this guy. I mean, he's obviously very important. Maybe he goes there on his own free will. I mean, Deadfinger is very powerful.
Well, where's this prison?
So Tratus comes in and he calls over, a skinnier guy, a littler person. And he walks over and he puts this piece of parchment on the table and sticks a knife in the top of it. And he goes... You know, are these the guys that's going to Destron? And he looks at you all and he goes, I don't know, are you all?
Well, hell yeah.
So he says, if you guys want to undertake this, you know, and you get the job done, you know, we'll welcome you into the Grey Rock, and we'll do, you know, we'll be a resource for you if you ever need our help for anything. So basically, the map that you are looking at here looks like this right here. They kind of went and scouted out the front of the prison, and, you know, all of these notes on here just pretend they're written in, like, Elvish and, you know, whatever. It's like, whatever. I can't do old parchment, crazy handwriting on this thing. So, kind of from what they get, you know, they go in at night, and they kind of, like, look around, and they basically stealth through the outside and kind of stay out of, you know, harm sight. He said one guy was able to make it in and really take a good look around this place, and this is kind of what he's seeing. He said, like, in the back, up here, you got the warden's quarters. I'm trying to figure out how do you ping? There it is. You got the warden's quarters over here. You got the supply closet, where basically they keep all their food and rations and everything. And this right here, they couldn't get inside, but, you know, they suspect this is where the dungeon entrance is, where they keep all the prisoners. Because, you know, whenever the prison carts come up, you know, that's where all the prisoners get off and go down. They also said, you know, there's a few things you need to be aware of. They said the security is going to be heightened at night because of the low visibility. And during the day, they're going to have a lot less guards, but of course, they're going to have the visibility they need to see from, you know, far away.
I have a question. Are there guards inside, or are they pretty much only watching the wall?
He said that during the nighttime, he saw some guards patrolling inside the walls, and he said he saw about 4 to 6 guards on the gate. During the daytime, it looked like there were like 2 to 3 guards, and they couldn't even get inside during the day just because the visibility was so open, so they honestly have no idea.
How many guards patrol inside?
They said probably, like, you know, they saw maybe 4 to 5 just walking around, different people. Could be more. It's hard to tell kind of at night. You can only kind of see what guards you see. You can't really see their face or any characteristics about them that's identifiable.
So what is this supply cart during day, prisoner transport at night?
All right, so they also noticed that, you know, they kind of camped out and did like a stakeout and had mocha frappuccinos with each other and stuff while they were watching. And during the daytime, they said, you know, basically a couple of rickety old carts come rolling through. And from what they see, you know, that's like the supply cart, because they're like seeing in the gate. They're saying that the cart stops about right here, and then they unload it and move everything over to the supply closet.
Do they check the cart before it goes through the gate?
He said no. He didn't see anyone ever look at it. I mean, it's just supplies, so they have no reason to even check it or do anything with it.
Well, I was just thinking, the prisoner transport, me and Brian could pass as Endergaard soldiers and get in with the rest of you as prisoners.
Yep.
Yeah, okay. There are more guards walking around at night. We could, if they don't check the cart, we could do the same thing during the day and there'd be less people around.
What about the sewer entrance?
Oh, yeah, they said on the side there's a sewer entrance. And they said if you need to go in under the facility, you know, you can go in under that way, but you still have to find a way out. Like, you have to find a way up. So they said they have no idea where that leads or what it goes to. Like, no one's ever really been brave enough to go down it and come back out.
I asked the lizard man if he has any expertise in walking around in sewers.
No, not really. I mean, I spent most of my days inside a, you know, like a city. I grew up in the city.
All right, so I guess...
I look at the cleric and says, you're human garbage, right? What do you know about the sewer?
Ouch.
All right, so you guys kind of have, like, what's going on here. They also said, like, if you need to get around the back of it, you know, they didn't really mark it on the map or anything, but around the back there is, like, kind of a weaker section of the wall that maybe if you forced it a little bit, you would be able to get into it, come around the back of the prison, but they didn't do it, so they have no idea what's on the other side of the wall or if there's people back there or what.
Yeah, I mean, if we were, like, just knocked down the tension that we don't want.
Right. So it's kind of what you guys got going on for the prison. How do you guys want to approach this?
Are there guards inside during the day?
What's up?
Are there guards inside during the day?
They said the only guards that they saw during the day, since they couldn't get in, was through the gate unloading the cart. So they assume that they're there, but I mean, they could be in the warden's quarters hanging out during the day or, you know.
I mean, I feel like they could probably, yeah, as I say, I feel like there's probably, if there's 4 to 6 outside at night, there's probably that many during the day. They just may not all be outside. They don't need as many when they can actually see what's coming.
Right.
These guards are pretty heavily armed.
He said not really, you know, they have just like scale mail on. They just have like long swords and shields or, you know, just a long sword, no shield, like just stuff like that. Yeah, I mean, they're not, it's not like they're walking around with great swords and plate armor or anything.
I like Matt's idea.
I mean, I kind of like the Trojan horse idea with the cart. I also like the idea of just of trying, you know, if all the guards, you know, potentially are going to be outside, out the front gate at night. If we go in through the sewer, come up from the inside, you know, we might be able to see them, catch them from behind, or maybe not even have to catch them at all. They're all out front. They may not ever have to see us.
There might not be a way up from the sewer, though.
Well, I mean, there would have to be some way up. I mean, the stuff coming out of the castle or out of the prison has to come from somewhere.
A shitter.
I mean, that's...
I'm a big boy. I don't know if I can fit through a shithole.
Lizard man. I agree, I guess.
I'm a growing boy, damn it.
I mean, I'm fine with whatever you guys want to do.
I mean, you can all do different things as well. I mean, you don't have to do whatever everyone else wants to do.
Is there any kind of roof access?
No, not really. I mean, unless you bring some type of rope or a ladder, you're not really going to get up there.
I mean, they probably have a rope in camp here.
I have a somewhat unorthodox idea as to how we can get in. Does anyone have any nieces or nephews in the Girl Scouts?
Would you guys like
to buy some potions?
Anyway, sorry. Go ahead. So yeah, whatever you guys want to do. I like the idea. I'm not a just fucking go up there at the night and wreck them all. That's cool.
We could go up during the day and wreck them all if there's only 2 or 3 out front.
Yeah, but well, yeah, I guess we could. Then we just won't have. But that would give them time to raid.
That's true.
Maybe, you know, we get there at night, beat some ass, or we, you know, I still like the idea of trying to sneak into the sewer. I would be willing to try that. If you guys want to go one way, I would be willing to go. Somebody else wants to come with me. But we'll see what happens. You know, it's whatever you want to do. What?
Okay. So is that the game plan? So we got Brian and Matt going in a cart with the prisoners. Or are you guys going in with the supplies? Because remember, supplies are at day, prisoners are at night.
Well, we could do that, and then they could stealth through the sewer entrance, too, at the same time.
Yeah, they could do that.
We don't know where it comes up at. We could be down there for a while, and you guys be by yourself.
I don't think we have to worry about it, because we're one of them, technically. Like, we can walk around willy-nilly, I would assume.
Does Baron assume that?
Baron's pretty sure that he can pull rank and get us in.
I mean, I think we should all stay together in case.
Yeah, I think doing the nighttime thing would just be easier because we're going to have these additional, you know, four dudes in a car. It just makes it easier if we're acting as prisoners. We don't have to hide or anything. We'll be there. And then when shit goes sour, we can all just jump on them.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm digging it.
So all of us go prisoner transport at night?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
So we're going to sneak in prisoner transport style. Transport.
Now, how far away is this place?
It's going to take you all a while to get there. I would say hours.
Is anybody from the Grey Rock coming with us, or are we going by ourselves?
Actually, let me go ahead and tell you guys about a guy that's definitely gonna come with you guys. Okay. Right. Tradus offers you
not really for this.
Depending on what you need. He offers you some help. And let me find that help here just real quick.
God damn. It's gonna be a little donger.
So how are we going to convince them that they're prisoners?
We're just going to have some fake shackles and I'm going to be sitting in the bag looking down. We're going to go Skyrim with it.
Sorry, what's Skyrim?
We're just going to be sitting in the back of the cart while you guys are driving it. We're going to look real sad.
Skyrim is something similar to Carl's Jr., I believe. It's a mythical place.
All right, so Tradus tells you all, I have an expert at this sort of thing, okay? He's really good at getting in and out of places. And, you know, he can definitely help you all get in there and get out. I want you guys to meet John Patrick Mason. So John Mason walks up and he goes, hello.
God damn it.
I hear you all are going on a mission. I know you all weren't thinking of going without me, were ya?
Yeah, we didn't know you until right now.
Oh! Tradus, you never tell them about me until it's too late. And they go and die at the prison. Says, well, no matter. I swam that channel 7 years ago. Let's go, boys. So,
you've been in and out of prison a few times?
Yes. I've rolled through fire and opened doors for other people in there if I needed to. I've thwarted a biological attack on my people.
Have you ever been hunting in Africa?
No, but I've always wanted to go.
It's your horse.
Well,
named
sir,
the
you
Red
seem
October.
Like a pretty extraordinary gentleman.
There it is.
I was once that man, but no more.
Are you a Highlander?
Guys, we can't just say every Sean Connery movie. Okay?
Say, is this horse called the Red October?
This mission is called Mission Red October.
God damn it.
Can we call it Operation Zardoz?
Yes, yes, please.
Absolutely. All right, so Tradus is so you guys are planning on going in the prisoner transport. So I got to have one question for you. How the fuck are you going to get in there because you don't have a prisoner transport?
Hey, man, can I have some rope?
This is rope? Yeah. Yeah, we have plenty of rope. How much do you need?
Just like 40 feet.
All right.
Well, we could always hijack the prisoner transport.
Yeah, we could do that. We could catch it in transit.
They'll have everything we need.
Thanks for the rope. It had nothing to do with the plan.
Whatever you need to complete the job. So then John Mason's like, I know the schedules of the cots, like the back of my hand. I can show you where to go, gentlemen. So I guess that sounds good. So you guys are going to go in.
Yeah, let's jack the prison transport and then let's do this. I'm right.
Okay, so You got anything to do before y'all head out for this?
Yeah, it's still night, right?
Yeah.
All right. Can I have an aside with Shala?
Sure. All right. We're going to have to go into the other channel, but yeah.
All right, so the whole mind trip thing is not doing so well on him. He's having a hard time.
Okay.
Like, the whole time he's sitting there, he's really trying really hard to listen to what's going on, but he's having issues.
Okay.
So he's got, like, because Shala, she's a spirit walker, right?
Yeah, so she kind of
knows about this shit.
Right.
And so she needs, because he's having a hard time maintaining it on his own, so he kind of brings her, and she notices, you know, something's off about him, I'm okay. guessing, and she kind of notices, you know, hey, see you're struggling, what's the problem? And he tells her what's going on with him, and they have to do something to calm him down, because if he goes another too much longer like this, he's not going to be able to do anything.
Right.
Or something bad will happen.
So we'll say that, you know, she understands kind of what you're going through. Mm-hmm. She thought you were just a wizard. Mm-hmm. So, you know, she really didn't pay any mind to it. She just figured you were just disturbed, you know.
Yeah.
But after she figured out it's like the Eldritch Gods, we'll say that she brews some type of concoction for you and hands it to you. And we'll say you can write it on, like, your character sheet. She'll give you three vials of it.
Okay.
And we'll say that one vial will help you focus for, you know, however long, like between rests, if you need it. We'll say that it's a warlock Ritalin.
You know, like warlock Valium? Okay, gotcha.
Yeah. So, that should be good.
Okay.
But, all right, I guess we're back then.
Yeah.
And the ones at the gate are going to come in.
All right. So, John Mason gets you all to where you need to go. It takes y'all about, you know, 10 to 12 hours to get to this place. You guys are like probably like 2 to 3 miles from the prison, kind of watching for any approaching, you know, stagecoaches, you know, anything like that. Since it's during the nighttime, we'll say that it's just starting at nighttime, you know, since it's been about 12 hours and like it was kind of getting daybreak where you all were. So coming back around to nighttime, you guys are basically off to the side of the road hiding, and you all see the prisoner transport approaching. So what do you guys want to do?
Well, we have to stop him first, right? Can somebody just go play dead in the middle of the road, get him to stop?
I mean, me and Matt can just stand out in the middle of the road and be like, oh, hey, guys.
Okay.
I like this plan.
Warlock's got a lot of charisma. You could probably get him to stop, and then we can just take him off.
Normally, yes, but not at the moment.
Okay.
God damn it.
I've got charisma, too.
Oh, that'll probably work since you're in the garden with charisma.
Yeah.
Okay, so Brian and Matt are going to go stand in the road. Is that the plan at the moment?
I like this plan.
I sneak.
Okay.
Yeah, y'all. Alex also sneaks.
Yeah, you all need to roll stealth checks.
Everybody?
Yes. Everyone who's not standing in the room.
It's a D20 plus a dex, right?
I am the ether.
Holy shit.
I become one with the air.
You are the knight.
I am the knight.
Anyone know where Nazan went? Because I don't know. I kind of freaked out.
You hear from the darkness, ask them about Rachel.
Where's Rachel?
Where's Rachel?
Does that matter? Never mind that. No other one's saving throws.
So did we just leave Alex in the town?
He's asleep. And it's God the rhythm of the night. You stand in the middle of the road with a boombox playing that?
Right. So let's see what everyone got. Chris got a 15. Ben got a 10. Ben, you get advantage of stealth since you're a rogue, so roll one more. Okay. All right.
And I think that's it, right? It's just you four over there?
Yeah.
Three, I mean. Okay. So, the stagecoach kind of approaches with the prison guard, transport. Ryan and Matt, you all notice that there are two people in the front seat of the stagecoach, and that's all you can really see. So, as they approach you, they get kind of close to you, and they just, like, slow down and stop. I mean, they're not alarmed or anything. You're wearing, like, Indiguard armor.
Is it, like, a horse-drawn carriage?
Yeah.
I'm gonna, like, hold on to the reins of the horse. Like,
okay. Yeah, it's two heist.
What?
It's plural for horse.
Oh, my bad.
Two heist. As they stop...
No, go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
I was going to say, I ask them if they're destined for, like, their destination is the prison, I guess.
Okay. The driver looks at it and he goes, "What? Do you not know the name of the prison? I mean, you work there, right?"
Whatever.
All right, you have to forgive my friend here. He's a little new. Clearly, we're going to the prison.
Whose name Brian mentioned instead of saying prison.
He's like, okay, so you guys are going to the prison, right? do you guys happen to know the name of it by chance? I'm just wondering, like, because I mean, y'all work there. I'm assuming.
Are y'all gonna roll for bluffs and shit?
Clearly I don't work there. I'm a paladin. I work at the holy place.
What are you talking about?
Can I roll to recall the name of the prison?
I sneak up behind the cart and stab the driver.
Oh, what the hell?
It was just painful to watch. Nizan applauds from the back, from the ether.
I'm going to go ahead and take out the passenger.
All right, so hang on, we gotta do this.
Wait well, a minute.
I'm gonna have to be there too. Then I can't.
How many prisoners are in the back of this cart?
Y'all have no idea. Like, there was no
look, we're gonna cross that bridge when we come to it. Right now, we just need to get rid of these two.
All right, so that's fine. So Ben, you're gonna roll behind this guy. Rolled a 10 for stealth, but it's like fucking nighttime, and you're quiet. Talking. Yeah, he's like not paying attention, so you're good. Do me a favor, roll to hit him.
Let me see if I can remember what I add to that.
Is it his dex?
It's your proficiency plus your dex modifier if you're using a dagger or a short sword.
Wow. Oh, wait, it's a sneak attack. Does that mean I get
advantage on it?
I don't think you get advantage on it, but I think you just get more damage once you hit him.
Okay.
I think it's like a 1d6 extra damage.
Well, given that... are we going to assume that that's not a hit?
What, the 20 that Justin just rolled?
No, I'm talking about the... Wait, what 20?
No,
I'm sorry.
Ben rolled an 8.
Two scrolled up. So, Ben is going to swing at this guard and completely miss him.
All right, so...
Oh.
Since he misses...
Nick, hang on.
Like, flooding the chat with the...
Guard completely misses it. Has no idea it's happening.
What am I doing?
I was gonna
say you're like flooding the chat with the description of transmutation.
Oh, sorry.
That's okay. I thought you were doing it to recruit like. To,
so
no, I'm just like around. I'm digging around with my spell. I found the character.
So we're like looking at this going down. So we see Ben come up behind him and swing and miss, and the guy still doesn't notice it.
Wait, right. Can I? He doesn't
like,
notice it.
So he's like Byron make a face like.
Yeah. I mean, I would assume so.
Oh,
I do a song and dance to distract the guards so we can attack them again.
Wait a
I'm like, hey, look at me. And I just start dancing.
So look, I rolled a 15. I had a 15. So that's pretty solid. Let me just try to hit this guard that Ben missed.
I mean, you guys are like 30 feet away behind a rock. I mean,
what about Ben? Ben wasn't behind the rock.
Ben said he snuck up on him.
Okay.
So what? So you gonna sneak? You gonna sneak up on him?
My big clangy dragon man, sneak up.
Yeah,
on
him? He rolled a 15 on his stealth.
Yeah.
But I'm a disadvantage for stealth because I have.
What's the proficiency bonus too? Right.
Yeah.
Do I need to roll another?
Yeah.
Another stealth check.
Take so for lure. Me to throw the belly hammer, it's
all right. Two, so it's still 15.
My dexterity, right?
Correct.
All right, so
we'll let Chris do what he's gonna do real quick.
Yep.
All I'm gonna do is just what Ben did. I'm just gonna try to sneak up and hit the guy that he missed.
Okay. So I'd say you got up behind him pretty good, right, without him noticing you, because he's looking at Matt dancing and singing right now.
God damn it! So then I rolled. What was it?
Once I was a cleric man in the Church of Gods. I had a lot of fun, and then I killed a bunch of gods. You know, like that's what he's doing. He's just dancing.
I like this. So it's proficiency plus strength.
Yep, for your attack roll.
For hit to hit, right? Ooh, yep. Okay, there's a 12.
Okay. You don't hit a meat.
Can I just take out my sword and take out the guy?
Oh, hang on. So you swing real quick. I'm going to GM roll this real quick. He doesn't notice you swing at him.
Okay.
How dark is it outside exactly?
Okay, I cast Charm Person, okay?
I'm a 6-foot lizard man. How the hell did he not know? Wearing chainmail.
When you roll a 2 for trying to figure out what's going on, that's what happens.
Like, he's dancing real hard.
Does a 17 hit him with Charm Person?
Yeah, for sure.
Okay. I tell him to get off the cart, take off his shit, and run until he can't run anymore.
Wait, how does... Okay, so how
I
does
tell Charm... the other one to flee with command?
Okay. So
he has to make.
Are you guys coming out of stealth and stuff right now?
Well, I'm like, I'm from the stealth. I'm just doing the spell cast at him because I see this shit show going on, and I'm just done with it.
All right. So we'll say since you casted a spell, you like light up,
in
the distance and shoot this spell at this guy, and then you say like in a very commanding voice, like. Take all of your armor off and run down the road.
No, tell him to run into the woods until he can't, until he literally collapses.
This guy is petrified, right? And you also charmed him.
Yeah. So he has to do what I tell him to do, basically. As long as it's not directly harmful to him, and taking off his shit and running until he collapses isn't directly harmful.
Okay. Here's the
bad guy's got to make that saving throw, though.
Yeah, he tried.
Oh, okay.
Here's the problem we've got. We have one other person sitting on the cart.
Well, he's surrounded by four motherfuckers. I'm hoping you guys can take care of the one, since I took care of the other one.
All right.
I'm throwing a belly hammer at this guy sitting here.
Hang on.
Jesus fuck.
Let's back up real quick. Justin, when you charm someone, they think of you as a friendly acquaintance, right?
Yeah.
So surely there is a more useful way you could put this guy to work.
He could actually drive us into the prison, being as he's a prisoner.
He could, but only lasts an hour. Are we less than an hour away?
Yeah.
Okay.
I think he said we're 2 or 3 miles out.
Okay, yeah. So let's say, like, I'm guessing one of these guys is, like, the little leader.
Yeah, we'll say the driver kind of looks like he's the more dominant one.
So I'm like, cooperate with whatever the fat one tells you.
You're telling the...
The driver.
All right, Matt. Okay. So what do you got to tell him?
No, Byron, I am referring... He has to do what you tell him.
Okay. Well, I am I'm not fat, okay, you fucking spiritual asshole. I am quite healthy.
Okay.
As a dwarven man.
Okay, we can have this discussion later. We'll arm wrestle.
So the other guard stands up in the cart and just says, "What the fuck is going on?"
I swing my sword at him.
All right, I'll give you. So let's say he stands up in the passenger side of the cart. You're kind of on the side of it now, you know. So you're just gonna like swing at his legs, pretty much.
Oh, it's a great sword. Can I just like take it over my head and just fucking
holy cut him down the middle? Okay, yeah. Pretty brutal.
Warper, which adds another attack, I guess.
Okay.
What are you, the fucking mountain? You're trying to cut this back?
Drolic casts Hambone Malone.
So,
oh, I just want to kill him in one hit. Hold on, let me look up Warpriest. It's in my spell. No, it's not.
I mean,
I think it was a D8 damage. All right, I'm about to roll.
Yeah, you definitely hit him.
Okay.
Hit an Elder Dragon with that roll.
Fucking grandmother feels it.
Yeah.
All right, just a second. Why is my... What the fuck? My character sheet is bringing up my spinner. And then I think Warpriest is a D8.
Jesus Christ. Since when do clerics do damage? Okay.
No, he didn't do that, right? Did he? Yeah, he did.
Yeah, I think Warpriest.
No, you're good.
He just capitalized in to confuse you.
So you do 20 damage to this dude. You literally cut him from, like, the chest down. And then you pull back, and then you stab him in the chest and lift him up off the cart and just slam him into the ground. You pull your sword out, reach up, and with a whirlish dervish, you bring your sword down and decapitate him as he's laying on the ground.
Whoa.
The other guard stands up suddenly, and he looks at you.
Don't worry about it, buddy.
Well, he looks at Matt, and he goes, I fucking hated that guy. Thank you so much. What do you all need done here?
Alright, so we've got some prisoners we want to take into the prison along with your cart of people here.
Okay.
All right. How are the prisoners reacting to that just happening?
They're, you know what? They're fucking locked in the back. Who cares about those guys? They're all fucking shitheads anyway. Anyway, so you need me to drive you into the prison. Is that's what you need?
Yes, as you can tell, I'm a healthy man and I'm tired of walking, so I would like to bring my prisoners into this cart and ride with you.
Okay.
I'm tired of dragging their asses.
Okay, I feel that. Well, here's what we're gonna do. I can't take all of you all.
Well, how many prisoners are there?
You know what? Everyone just roll a perception check real quick.
What is it? D20 plus what?
Plus your perception.
Oh, yeah. I'm a dumbass. My bad.
Okay. Okay, so Matt, Chris, and Brian notice that the prisoners are running down the road as fast as possible right now.
Let him go. Fuck it.
Hey, does anybody have some Clorox wipes? We need to clean the rest of the blood out.
God damn it, Ben.
Can we take the guard that Matt decapitated and do like a Weekend at Bernie's thing to get him with him?
No, we have like some sticks we can put in the torso and shit to pop him up at least, you know?
Sorry, anyway, we
is
don't
know. What you all want to do? I'll be
no,
with
can we
it?
Just throw his ass in the ditch across the road or something?
Damn, yeah, it's so brutal.
Let's just find some bushes and throw
him
in there.
Yeah, just throw him down the fucking thing. Kick the head down. I don't even bother picking the head up. I'm just kicking it as they're carrying the body.
But we need.
I just want to scream out. God forgives you.
God forgives you. We need to get the rest of the blood off.
The Zahn shouts back. God doesn't give a shit about any of us.
I just want Hazan to notice that. Just look back. I want to grab the belly ham. Just look at him. Just like son of a bitch. Just fucking.
You're like here for okay, the deep. So... I love you, bro.
So is there room in the cart now for all of the guys as prisoners, and then one of us to ride on top?
Well, absolutely. Well, it
looks like we made room, driver.
And then like I can just walk beside it, I guess, or.
Oh, I'm riding. I'm shotgun. Rosa Parks, not moving to the back.
Yeah. I mean, is that how y'all want to do it? Everyone in the back, Matt walking beside
it. I got a
priest. You should probably get in with us. You'll seem suspicious walking along the cart like that.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
All right, I whispered to Carlor. I was like, whenever we get this cart there, I need you to snap this driver's neck because the spell's going to wear off.
This is your problem.
The driver says if you need me to, I'll snap my own neck. Just tell me. It's not a big deal.
Okay. We're good then.
I kind of want to see that.
Just puts it in the wheel and drives.
Oh my God.
All right. So you guys loaded up, ready to go. Ben, you wanted to wipe the blood off. You wipe all the blood off. You get it all cleaned up. Everything looks snazzy. And you guys are going to,
That was such a shit show. God damn it.
I didn't expect it to go like that at all.
We have bad luck with initiating things. Yeah. Like Matt almost killed us twice the last time.
Yeah. I hit Nazan in the face with that belly hammer.
God damn it.
Alright, so you guys throw your characters on here. We'll get ready.
Where are we at?
Wait, do I not have it on here?
All I see is the prison.
Please hold.
Still only see the prison. Oh, now I see a section of the road.
Yep.
Darkness.
Darkness. Spreading. You also have to remember that John Mason is still with you all as well. He's in the back with you guys.
How did he feel about all that?
He said, jolly good show. I haven't seen a head cut off like that since Vietnam.
That's in Vietnam.
The fuck are you talking about, John Mason, you weirdo?
You need to work a stupid boy into there, too.
Such a stupid paladin.
Oh, goddamn.
Okay, you mushmouth fuck.
Fucking paladin.
Very, very foul-mouthed paladin.
It's amazing.
Egon, did your character have a tail?
No.
Okay.
What? Why don't you have a tail?
They don't have tails. I don't know.
I mean, lizards can just lose their tail. Maybe I fucking saw him and I was like, ooh, tail. And he was just like, shit, and it popped off.
I don't know if I have a tail or not, but I definitely have a tail.
Are you saying you got tail like a big old butt? Or are you saying tail like...
He's saying regardless of whether his character would have a tail in the D&D universe, his character absolutely has a tail.
I'm going to hit somebody in the eye.
If we grab your tail, you lose all power and freeze.
Nope.
Just saying, if we're crammed in this little cage together, you might not want to touch me with your tail.
That's why I'm riding shotgun. Rosa Parks, not moving to the back.
Over here on this side of the wagon.
Yeah, you're good.
Alright, so
We're all in the wagon. We have our weapons on the ground. Looks like our hands are bound.
All right, so you guys are riding up to the gate. And just so you all get up here to the gate here.
Oh, my. I have a question.
Yeah.
Before Brian. My question is, what sort of wagon are we in? Is this like a covered, or is it just like a
it's a jack tree? Wagon.
It's a jack wagon. It's an enclosed, like, wagon.
Okay. The only reason I ask is because are we sitting in the back fully armed and armored?
Yes.
Oh, good. Okay.
I mean, you guys didn't take anything off or do anything, so.
Right. Well, that was my question. I just wanted to make sure. Okay, cool.
Yeah. All right. So you get up to the gate, and this guard walks on over here, and I need to copy this guy and put this guard here. So he's driving this bad boy.
Oh, I like it.
And he walks up.
Hello? Who is Kevin? Rip Kevin? Well, good news is I just finished downloading The Rock. So I'm going to put that on my Plex server for later.
Hello?
Mm-hmm. Hey, it's Kevin.
Shit, bro. So,
I don't know if you heard me, Kevin, but I just finished downloading.
Finished downloading what?
The Rock.
Oh, shit.
It's going up on my Plex server right now. Anyway, what's up?
Let's go. So the guard walks up to the driver, and he looks at the driver, and he says, "Hey, Roy, how you been? You doing good? How's the family doing?" Roy looks at him. He's like, "They're pretty good. How have you been doing?" I hear your wife just had a baby. He's like, "Yeah, she's doing all right. I was thinking about raising him to be a big old mountain boy with uses a two-handed sword. He's going to join the Indigard army. He's going to be crazy. He's going to be sick. We named him Mason Jar because there's nothing stronger than a fucking Mason Jar."
Is that a John Mason Jar?
The voice from the back says.
Hear that from the back?
Quiet down back there. Anyway, sorry.
So Cecil looks over and he goes, "Who's your fat dwarven friend over there? He's such a fat one, isn't he?"
Oh, here we fucking go. Motherfucker.
Cecil.
Name's Baron there, dumbass.
It's like, "Dumbass? You haven't even been here before. I haven't even seen you around. What do you even do here?"
I open mason jars, oddly enough.
You just imply he's going to have sex with his kid?
Please. Jesus Christ. got dark real quick. Do they have a bluff that you can roll?
I don't know.
I mean, there's deception.
Roll deception.
Everybody or just Brian?
Just Brian. He's in the hot seat.
Well, it's going to get interesting, boys.
He's like, "So I hired you to open mason jars in the back. We needed one of them. It's good that they got someone like you. It's a big, strong dwarf with his big, strong hands."
I whispered to Brian to stop fucking this up.
Hey,
pipe down, prisoner.
God damn it. Yes.
Did you add your charisma to that, Brian?
No.
Your charisma modifier? I mean, that's your deception.
Yeah.
Well, no, never mind. Not if you don't. If you don't take it. But I don't know how that works.
I didn't have a deception point, but.
Yeah, I mean, you still roll your charisma modifier. If you're trained in it, it just gives you the proficiency bonus to you.
Ah, okay.
So, you rolled, what, a 13, 14?
16.
16, okay. Yeah, you're fine. So, Cecil over here looks over and he says, "You know what? I just need to get these prisoners in here. You know, I'm sorry to break it up quick. You know, but you know, we're just gonna go on in if that's cool. It's like the paladin over here. He's kind of riding with me. You know, he's kind of getting his bearings here on the prison. You know, just doing a little friend time, having a good time together. Cecil's like, all right, that sounds good. He's like, you better watch your fucking mouth, paladin. I'll have you shipped out of here in no time.
Oh, no.
God damn it. All right, so old Cecil goes back here.
I just want to look over at Cecil as we ride by. I want to do like a mason jar open. Like, oh. Huh?
It's a good, good taunt, the mason jar. So we'll say that you guys get all the way in here.
I throw in the loser your mason jar at him. No, I don't.
we'll open up this much, and we'll see you guys are like... See you guys are like right here with the cart.
Hey, look, more guards.
So
interesting.
So it's probably been about 50 minutes to 55 minutes.
So we're about to lose Cecil, is what you're saying.
All right, let's see. So old Roy gets off the. It's actually Roy. Cecil was the guard on the
cart. Oh, my bad. Yeah, we're about to lose Roy.
So Roy gets off the cart, kind of walks. Well, over.
Can he? Can we have him come into the back and like look like he's gonna release, like open up the back and then snap his own neck and put the body in the back?
I mean, he could, but how are you gonna tell him to do that right now?
I need. Is there a way we have Cecil just knock himself out? Because you know I'm.
It's Roy, not Cecil.
I can't, Roy. I can't rightly kill Roy. You know, he's been a pretty okay dude thus far.
I can. Family. Roy, come back here and let us out and snap your own neck.
Says it out loud.
What are we going to do? Are we going to let Mr. Bellyhammer take us over to the dungeon entrance, or are we just going to start killing fools?
I have a question real quick.
Yes.
About the surroundings. The guards that are out front.
Yeah.
Can they see into here where we are?
The two guards in the back, like this guy.
Okay.
This guy, they can definitely see.
Okay. All right, that's fine.
Behind you. But the rest of them are looking forward. They're not paying attention to what's going on in the walls.
I got you. And it's also nighttime. Okay, that's cool.
So, all right. So
we'll keep going right here.
So Ben's going to sneak. Now, when you all got into the back, I mean, you didn't lock the door or anything. I know it's wide open. I mean, but, you know, where you all are, it's kind of, you guys are kind of in the middle of the place. You know, and you got to remember that we'll say that John Mason whispers to you all, the last scout that looked at this, he noticed that the guards came and helped with the prisoners to get them down to the prisoner shelves. So he's like letting you all know, you know, there could be something going on. Hang on a sec.
I mean, we only got a couple minutes left to deal with Roy, so he either needs to die or otherwise be indisposed of.
How about we have Roy run off and, like, Roy, today I need you to say something ridiculous, so the next thing you say is going to sound even more ridiculous.
Wait for Kevin to be back.
Let me check something.
I need Roy to say something along the lines of, I fuck chickens.
When the spell ends, it knows it has been charmed.
Well, you gotta die.
Yeah, he gets pissed off at you when the spell wears off.
Yeah, so he's immediately gonna call out.
So is it particularly dark in this place?
Oh, we don't know yet.
I'm just saying, we have to make sure he's unconscious or dead.
I'm going to say probably not dark.
All right.
Just so I'm not paying attention.
All right, so what's going on?
She says when the spell ends, the sky's going to turn on us immediately, so...
I need to...
put in Roy's head since Roy listens to me, and I have to do this for the chaotic good, okay. The chaotic neutral person that I am. Roy, you know, suicide is not a bad option right now. Your life's pretty shitty.
You're at the worst, pal.
Meanwhile, this other guard's listening to this happen because he's right next to him.
Yeah, he's like, what?
Roy, Justin, tell him to attack that guard next to him.
Roy's been going through some shit, buddy. All right. I'm just here to help him. As his holy advisor, it's not a bad idea for him to just swallow a sword right now.
All right, Roy. Roy reaches down and he goes, you know what? I think
today, Junior.
Yo, I just that. Hang on one second. It's like, you know, I feel like, you know, the time that that we've been together has been great. Baron, I mean, you've been a friend to me, you know, and God damn it, I feel like I've known you my whole life, and I just feel so close to you right now, and I'm gonna be honest with you, I've been thinking about killing myself for years now. My life's in shambles, my wife left me for the masonry guy. I mean, he was a mason jar opener, much like yourself. And I mean, you remind me of him, but there's just something about you. It's like I'm under a spell, you know? That's kind of how I feel right now.
Zahn chuckles in the back.
meanwhile, while this is going on, the other guard is going, he's like, what?
What?
What the fuck is going on? So, hang on, back to it. It's like, you know what? I'm going to do it. I'm going to be brave this time. I'm not going to be like when my wife left me and when I lost all my gold trying to sell our house that we built together. I'm going to do it this time. Roy takes the dagger, shoves it straight into his throat, falls out of the carriage onto the ground next to the carriage.
Falls onto that guy?
Yeah.
No, of course, the guards, he's not going to know that we charmed him, so we can play this off.
Right. Guard just looks up at Brian and he goes, what the fuck just happened?
Like I said, I mean, he's just, like you said, he's been going through some shit.
Roll deception.
God damn it.
If you botch, we charmed him.
Christmas added onto that, is that right?
Plus one, yeah.
Chris, what kind of weapon do you carry?
I have a longsword. Well, I have a longsword, a rapier, and a dagger.
Oh, sword McSorty pants.
Yeah.
General Grievous, 0.5.
I don't carry them all at the same time. I don't use them all at the same time.
All right, so
should've gotten a tail.
So anyway, after all of that shit, this went fucking down. The guard starts talking to Brian, and he's like, "All right, I got you. You know, Roy was a good guy. And it's gonna be really sad to see him gone."
Yeah.
Anyway. What kind of prisoners you got tonight? How many of them you got back there?
I've got like, what is it, like four assholes. Like, they just...
Six.
Five.
Are they... 30.
I can't...
Can we roll a math check?
30 strong men.
Sean Connery and... did Alex come with us?
No.
No, he's still sleeping.
Oh, that's okay. Right. Sean Connery didn't have a character icon. So I got five assholes back here. One of them with a speech impediment annoys the shit out of me. But yeah, okay. They're assholes.
Okay. Do you need any help or anything getting them to the prison or?
Yeah. We're gonna need all these guys to help us out here. They're a rambunctious crew.
Okay, so you're going to need multiple guards to come help you out, get them out of the back, and take them to the prison?
I'm thinking just the four guys here, or three guys, and you. I think we got it.
So what about our weapons?
Yeah, we're armed back here.
I mean, he's drawing them back to Brian, fight.
Brian's calling it. You guys can hear everything that's going on.
Yeah.
So we're getting ready then.
Yeah, so guards call these guys over. We're going to say that they're coming in the back here, and they're going to work on opening this up. Brian said he wanted three guys to come help, so he's doing a good job. I guess you should also fire Brian after this.
Well, I've got my sword on the floor, and I'm ready to, like,
throw it into the guy as soon as he opens the gate. We get some sneak, you know, some advantage here, because it's going to be fucking... This is Sparta. Kick open the doors on them, because them doors aren't locked. So I'm actually going to stand, like, right... Yeah.
Okay. So...
I'm ready to roll. I need to jump out, too, so...
All right, we'll say that, you know, guards open. What's up?
Well, what about that other guard?
What do you mean? Guy this guy?
Door up front.
He's dead.
No, the guy by the dungeon entrance.
This guy?
No, the guy on the right, all the way on the right.
Oh, well, I mean, Brian only said he wanted three guards.
Oh, okay. All right,
so this guy's just over there. He's over there checking his Facebook.
Pretty much. He's just supervising.
On his scrying stone.
I was going to say his face folio.
Okay, so are we going to kick open the doors? Or are we going to wait for him to open them and then jump them, or what?
Either way, we're going to have to fight every guard on the screen.
I'm done with it.
Unless we,
Hold on. Can I use, what is it, Demergy or whatever to put out all the torches?
What is it?
It's, what is it called? Thaumaturgy or whatever.
I don't know if you can put them out.
Thaumaturgy, yeah.
It can manipulate small campfires, so I mean, a torch could.
Yeah. Okay.
But I don't think I can do all of them at once.
Well, if you get a strong enough roll, maybe.
You get the one on the balcony, basically.
Okay, so we'll say that you use the spell, that's fine. And, yeah, pretty much all of the guards' torches up on the wall go out, and all of the guards opening the back doors go out and everything. So it's basically completely black, and we'll say you do it right as they're getting the door open, so they can't really see into the card anymore.
We only have two people with dark vision.
Yeah, so what do you guys want to do?
I mean...
They can't really see you all at all. They just... see, like, silhouettes in the back of the car.
Well, if they can't see us, we should just bail out and head for the door.
Wait, what?
Oh, they can't see. They're in the way? Well, fuck it. Then let's just fucking murder them.
Okay. So, I'll say that you all get an attack of opportunity here. I mean, obviously, because these guards are like, why the fuck did my torch go out? And you guys are getting ready to shove a sword in their face.
We can roll an initiative.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Good old Norman Reedus.
Fucking Norman Reedus. I forgot about him.
Alright. So. Alright, so who's going first?
Chris Moore.
And then.
Same guards. Of course, they have to skip one turn. Because you all got to take off.
Brian, and then me, Justin,
and then Matt.
Wait, what did Matt roll?
Rolling three.
What about John Patrick Mason, General Shaw?
He's not fighting. He's staying in the back of the car.
He is an advisor.
Does he have the squeeze bottle full? He's there.
Yeah, he's he actually has smoke. Like in powder form, and he throws it, and it like disappears.
God damn it!
All right, so Chris, you're up first.
All right. Well, I'm just gonna roll. I mean, I'm just gonna attack this guard closest to me here with my rapier.
Okay.
So I'm gonna roll. Let's see. Now to hit, it's just d20 plus my strength, right?
Right.
What's your proficiency?
Yeah, I'll be right back. I'm hearing something in my house.
That's not good.
Okay.
Well.
Right, Matt.
All right, dude.
You absolutely hit him.
All right, hang on. I need to find. Hang on. Trying to find the damn. If someone can find it faster, what's the damage? Never mind, I found it. 1d8.
All right, with my cat locked in a fucking room.
So 1d8 plus. Same thing, right? Strength and proficiency.
Yep. Yes.
All right.
Okay. So you deal 7 damage to this guy. You shove your rapier into his shoulder out of the darkness.
Okay.
And he is looking pretty bad. It's not good. So next up would be the guards, but they don't get to go this turn. Ben, what you got?
I'm going to throw a shuriken.
Okay.
I'm going to throw it at the guard Chris just attacked.
Okay.
Hold on, let me remember how much they do. Oh, and then I get I'll get sneak attack damage too.
Yep.
Oh.
All right.
Damn.
Did you? Okay. Yeah. You rolled tit. I'm sorry. I was looking at something else. Yeah. He's okay. So you throw a shuriken right into his face. Just fucking falls over dead. He gone.
Rip.
All right. So next up is Brian.
He also gone.
No, I'm here. So strength's 2, proficiency's 2.
Yep.
I should probably say I move.
Okay.
Hitting the guy.
The guy in the back?
Yep.
Okay.
And how'd you figure out the damage? What is it, a 1?
It's whatever. Using a great axe, right?
Yep.
So it's 1d, whatever the great axe is. I have no idea what it is.
I think it's a d10.
Oh, shit. I was supposed to get another 2 damage, but that's fine. Unless, well, maybe not. I don't think I do that yet. Ignore me.
Plus my strength and proficiency?
Yeah. For your damage, yeah.
Oh, wait, no. Great axe is a d12.
All right, so we'll say that we'll just add 2 onto your roll. So you did 16 damage. So you reach back with that big-ass great axe, and the dude in the back still trying to figure out what the fuck's going on. You cleave him literally in half.
Well,
rip.
Dude's laying on the floor. Justin's up next.
All right, so this last guy. I come out of darkness, I put my hand right up to his mouth, and I cast Eldritch Blast.
Okay.
Well, I figure I don't want it to, like, is this going to light up the area? And I figure if I get it right up against his fucking mouth, it's just going to hit him in the head, and it's not going to hit him in the mouth. It's not, it'll just fry his head.
Okay, well, yeah, you definitely hit him. Fucking 22. How much damage? Yeah, let me do it. Schmidt. Yeah, you guys do a shit ton of damage.
He's still alive?
Yeah.
He's probably not having a very good time at the moment, though.
He's in there. He ain't happy.
He ain't happy.
He's having a bad time.
All right, so I'm going to attack him.
All right. Okay, you hit him. And he's dead.
Really? Did any of the guards notice, you know, did they hear any noises or any of them alerted?
Yeah, I'm going to tell you all. But, Matt, what weapon are you using? Using a greatsword?
Yeah, a greatsword.
That's right.
And I'm war, so I've got proficiency with it.
I gotcha. So you basically just shove your greatsword through his neck, pull it out. Dude just falls down to his knees like fucking ridiculous video game style and then just flumps over into the floor.
While his head's on fire because of Eldritch Blast, I guess.
Yeah, his head's like glowing purple. He looks like fucking Deadpool with his mask off right now. Alright. So, these guys up here turn around and, they can't really see what's going on. All they see is Brian down there, trying to, like, fumble on top of the corpses and, like, get everything taken care of. But it's really dark, so they can't really see, make out exactly what's going on. And one of them yells,
"Are they elevated above?"
Yeah. They're probably, like, 15 feet up in the air. But, one of them yells down, hey, is there everything okay down there? We heard some scuffling.
Yeah, you know, fucking torches went out. The prisoners went stupid, but we got it.
All right, roll deception.
God damn it.
We're all fine here now, thank you. How are you?
Bad. Reactor leak. Got a reactor leak here. Very dangerous.
Oh, wait, my fucking...
It's a 9.
Yeah, I keep forgetting to add that one.
Okay. Alright, so yeah, he's like, okay, well, if you need any help, just let us know. We're up here.
Guards are all right, stupid. All right.
Appreciate you, good sir. Do you.
So, this guy, let's see what he's doing here. He kind of notices, hears some scuffling, can't see anything. So.
I have dark vision, so I can see him coming.
I do, okay.
Too. Isn't the shit closed off, though?
Like the where wagon. They're at?
No, the wagon.
Yeah.
No, it's... Oh, well, the wagons.
The back is opened up, but how we've been able, I'm just saying how we've been able to see.
Oh, I thought there were like, like holes in the side of it.
Yeah, yeah, there's like, yeah, you can see, like, see outside of it, but it's really hard to kind of see.
That roll was to sneak.
Okay.
And I'm going to get up around right here.
Okay.
And just kind of wait.
Okay. Well, this guy walks a little bit further. Just walks right past him.
Can I do that?
Well, he just diagonal stepped that motherfucker.
What's up?
Well, I'm going to just get behind him and keep following.
Okay.
While he walks up to Brian.
So he's just going to go right there and he's going to be talking to Brian. He's like, what was all that going on? Is everyone okay over here? And he kind of sees like bodies laying on the ground.
I roll to attack.
Okay. Do it up. So you get sneak attack to you. Okay. Yep. You hit him.
Remember what that was again? Okay.
Holy shit. God damn, y'all do so much damage.
For the first time ever in this game.
I know, right?
Normally we're the fucking five stooges.
Alright. You guys kill him. You guys are pretty good to go. You notice the guards up, like all you dark light people can see that they're kind of like trying to get the torches lit back up and ready to go.
Yeah, we should probably head for that door over there.
Can we clean up these bodies and throw them in this supply closet? Like,
let's just kill the rest of them.
God damn it.
They're up on a 15-foot wall.
I can get up there.
Okay. Who's going to hoist my fat ass up there? You got a rope? Oh, hope it's industrial strength.
I do have a rope.
Yeah, it's made by a druid.
Why don't you just throw your belly hammer up there?
Well, we could go in the gatehouse and just have them come down to us.
Is there a gatehouse?
I mean, they got up there somehow.
Can they hear us discussing this? Because this is a little weird.
I mean, not really, but they're lighting those. They're getting those torches lit back up pretty good.
Just put the bodies in the back of the wagon. Just put all these bodies in the wagon.
Let's do that.
Okay.
Because in real lineup, all they're going to see is just the wagon.
Okay, so you guys are going to put all the bodies into the old wagon here. And,
just close the wagon up.
Yeah. Here, I'm going to draw a square here to signify that they're in the wagon. Alright. So, you guys are kind of out in the middle of the courtyard here, trying to figure out what to do. John Mason jumps out of the back. He tells you all, "That was some mighty fine fighting. I really enjoyed it. It's one of my favorite parts of going on missions with you all. It's like, but listen, I have something to tell you all. We mustn't talk here. Let's get over in the shadows." So old John Mason, which, hang on, let me see if I can. This is absolutely perfect. John Mason.
God damn it.
So we'll have him like kind of scamper over here quietly. And that's kind of where he's gonna be at.
God damn it, Brian.
Shadows with you.
Alright.
Shingles, you say.
So he's like talking to you all and he's saying, "When I was here for my short period of stay, and I got out and I swam those 7 channels to get out of here back when I was your age. Like, listen, there was a man here. He went by the name of the Warden. He was a very tall, scary man. He was monstrous, very monstrous. He carried around a great sword that was great, and it was a sword. It's like, listen, we can kill him if you all would like to."
Do you think he would know where the, you know, he might know about the prisoner?
I mean, he's the Warden.
Where is he?
According to the scout reports, he's in the Warden's quarters.
God damn it, Ben.
Alright, so Ben's moving up here. We're going to say by now they got all the lights back on up top, so if you guys are going to move around, you want to kind of stick to the...
stay in the shadows.
Stay in the shadows. I'll also, if you guys are going to move back here, I'll kind of reveal this back here for you all.
Yeah, we'll go around the back of the place here and okay. Keep out of sight.
Am I still sneaking from before?
Yeah. We'll say you're all being, you're all kind of moving around here. Go ahead and roll another stealth check here. Ben, you don't have to.
I mean, should I? Since they, you know.
Well.
I mean, they can't really see us behind the building, can they?
Right.
I see them not being very stealthy and say, I'll scope out the area ahead real quick before we move on.
Okay, well, I mean, they can't see you, but I mean...
God damn it.
About this guy. So... Right. So this guy...
You have to take him out.
This guy kind of sees you, but he doesn't... Like, you know, it's still dark over here behind all the gates and stuff. He's just kind of patrolling, just kind of lackadaisically walking. So what do you got? How do you guys want to approach this situation?
I got it. They know me.
Okay.
Like, hey, bud, just taking these guys to the prison. And, yeah, we're just hanging out. No big deal.
Roll the hammer.
Please roll.
Belly. Oh yeah, it's a shaka booey.
Roll deception. Please roll one.
Oh god, what is this? Let's see.
So this guy can call in a helicopter attack on you.
D20 plus one.
Right. Oh, oh shit.
Oh, is that a natty twin?
Them natty peeps.
The most right. amount of natty peeps.
You clean, you knock his block off with that belly hammer.
Oh, wait, I didn't know it was belly hammer.
Yeah, are you belly hammering or deception?
Oh, I'm belly hammer. I didn't get close enough to hit him. No, I'm. That's a shakabooey belly hammer.
Shakabooey.
Alright, roll damage.
I gotta figure out the damage on this fucking thing.
It's a double damage, too, so this thing's just gonna clobber its face. Unless he rolls a 1 or something.
Shakabooey.
Oh, shit, I linked it. Nope. Alright. Light hammer. It's a D6. Is it plus strength? Dex?
It'd be dex since you're throwing, I think.
Yeah.
Throwing hammers are strength.
Oh, okay. There you go. It's strength, and then you get your proficiency to it as well. Because
you're just chucking that goddamn hammer.
You're proficient with it.
Shakabooey.
So you do 10 damage.
Was that enough to kill him?
No. Throws the old the belly hammer, and you hit this dude in the face with it. It knocks his helmet off, and it comes flying back around like a boomerang, and you catch it in midair. The dude is just fucking like flabbergasted and falls to the ground because you just fucking knocked his clock.
Do we need to roll initiative?
No. I mean, if you want to try and throw something at him, you should be good.
I'm gonna throw. So I got a dagger.
I mean,
never mind. Ben's going for shuriken.
Okay, so Ben throws and misses him.
Well, all right. I guess I'll try with my dagger.
Damn.
Never mind.
Justin's fucking torching him.
No. He said he's reeling right from this hammer.
Yeah, he's fucked.
I'm walking over to him. I grab him on his shoulder and we get real close to him and just and he's fucking out.
All right. So because you touched him, you let all the spirits into him, and it's just very painful for him and terrifying. So he starts screaming at the top of his lungs.
God damn it!
Because you did that. So.
Well, I mean, his nose. Look at this way. He's like holding his nose, right?
Yeah,
he's holding his nose. He's got his hands over his mouth. And he's like this, and I do that. He's like, and then, he passes out.
All
right,
here you go.
So I envisioned that going. If he was gonna scream, I'd just snap his neck.
With your tiny warlock fingers.
Yeah.
All I had to do, I was just gonna
think it's like more of like a Vulcan death pinch, you know.
Okay. We'll say since Brian moved up, you guys kinda get this area. Alright, so yeah. That makes sense. So you take him down with the Vulcan death pinch. And he's dead.
Powered
he's dead
by the Eldritch, but alright.
he made a lot of noise, so home slice here. So come walking around the corner. And then let me roll something.
I want to go up to him.
Well, hang on. I'm going to see if he sees what's going on. Okay, he does not. So you want to walk up to him?
Yeah, I'm going to walk up.
Throw him in face folio.
Huh? What was that?
I'm going to say, hey, take a look at this real quick. I'm going to swing my hammer or swing my sword at him.
You guys are just like... There's no diplomacy. It's just killing people.
Well, we can't have them yell.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Jesus.
All right. So, Matt, you do not... Wait. Yeah, you hit him. Okay.
Yeah, he hit him and he did damage.
Okay. So, yeah, deal 10 damage to him. So, you just swing your giant greatsword at this dude and hit him in the side. And he kind of wobbles because it like went into him, and he falls down too. He's kind of just like sitting there. So we got guys are kind of running out of time here.
Can I get up there and do some stabbing?
Get up there? I would say no, because you're 8 miles away.
Okay. Can I throw my dagger?
If you want to try it. Wait, didn't you already throw it?
No, I didn't get to, because Justin like threw his pinch at him.
By all means.
He threw his pinch at him. All right, so am I close enough? I don't even know if I'm close enough to throw my.
You can move six.
Yeah, you're probably close enough. It's like they generally have like a 60 to like 200 range or something like that.
I mean, I have a pretty big beefy dragon arm, I feel like.
He's only 40 away from you.
Alright, so let's just roll d20 plus 2. Oh, no, plus 4.
Please don't botch it.
You got it.
Alright, and then my dagger. Do I know what dagger damage is off the top of your head?
1d4 plus dex mod.
Plus proficiency?
Yeah.
Okay. 1d. Roll. Thank you, Nick.
That's interesting.
So, wait, we add proficiency to it?
To the damage?
No, proficiency to the.
Oh, to the hit?
Yeah.
Okay, well, then hang on. Well, then just add 2. Just, it's going to be 3 damages instead of 5.
Oh, he's still dead, even if he did 3 damage.
All right, cool.
So can we look around here and see if there's some kind of side entrance into the warden's quarters?
Sure. Roll it up.
I have dark vision. Can I not see? Can I see? I don't know if there's any way to do it in the program or not.
I mean, what you don't really see anything in there necessarily. There you don't see. See like anything on the wall or anything.
I'm trying to pick up my dagger.
Okay. Like that you're moving.
Oh, did you threw that dagger?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Then yeah, you use your dex mod.
Right, I did. I just didn't know if we used proficiency.
Right.
I would like to peek around this corner.
Okay.
And I'll just scoot the body back a little bit.
Since you got dark light by up to 40 feet, kind of see that going on over there.
Is this a building or like an up, a step up?
It's a giant building.
Okay. Well, I say we ignore that guy.
Okay.
Is this a step right here?
It's a door.
Yeah, doors are the big squares.
So we get in there without the guards on the wall noticing us?
Yeah, it's out of view of the guards on the wall. You guys are pretty safe.
I would like to try to peek in the door a little bit.
Like, how so? Like under it? You're gonna open it a little bit?
Is it just a solid door?
Yes.
Alright, yeah, I'll try to look under it.
Look under it, okay. You see, as you're looking under it, actually, roll perception. We'll see what you see. Okay, so you see, the legs of some tables in there. Looks to be really well lit in the room. Behind the table, there is another set of legs. But you only see one set. And then as you kind of move to the left a little bit, you can see another pair of set. But it looks like, you know, he's wearing like armored boots, where the other one looked like it was just like leather boots.
All right, so I can see 2 people in there.
Yeah. What y'all want?
So we just want to bust in, or...
You all bust in. I'm going to come over to this other door.
Shaka boy.
And when they're all distracted, I'm going to come in. Get some sneak.
How about you guys, prisoners, or people not of this place, go over to the other door. Me and Matt
We'll knock on this door and be like, "Oh, hey, what's going on? Sorry, we make a little distraction here."
Okay. So, you're gonna knock on the door, and then everyone else is gonna go over to the other door.
I mean, if that works for everybody else, huh?
Get there without being seen by the wall guys.
I mean, it's quite a way away there.
Yeah, me and Chris are hidden, so why don't we just hang out here?
Yeah, you all can hang out there, and I am still sneaking.
Yeah, he's still sneaking. He can go over there, and he can look, and we can hang out here. So whenever it invariably goes bad, whenever you knock on this door.
Yep. Okay, so you guys knock on... God damn it. So you knock on the door, you wait about 10 seconds, and nothing happens. Like, no answer, nothing. Knocking harder, okay. So at this point, you hear like walking towards the door. The door opens a little bit, and it's like an elvish guard looking guy. And he like opens the door and he goes, "Can I help you at all?"
I gotta pee.
All right, roll deception.
I mean, he might really have to pee.
All right,
plus one.
So you said you can pee. There's an outhouse in the supply room. Why are you coming in here? Why do you need to come in here? This is where the warden does his work. I mean, you shouldn't be interrupting him. I mean, you know this if you work here.
There's someone in that bathroom. And they're taking their sweet time, so I really, really need to pee. And I'm a shy peer, so I just can't go around the corner or anything.
Well, he's talking to him. Can I just... I'm trying to cast Charm Person over his shoulder.
Yeah?
Yeah, so I did that.
Oh my gosh, okay. So,
I like that Justin has zero faith in Brian.
Yeah.
I'm just backing him up. The thing is, he doesn't see me doing this, right? So I'm making it. I'm trying to make it seem like he thinks he
would see you doing that.
Who? What?
Whoever you're trying to cast it on, you think you'd have to have line of sight, and you're gonna like glow blue.
No, I mean he's like, no, I'm not glowing. I'm back here, hidden behind this building, looking around the corner. The guy said he's poking his head out the door. I can see him.
Yeah, he can't really see outside too well. Plus, it's like light where he is and dark outside.
Yeah.
So, he it absolutely hits him.
Okay.
And he just looks at Brian and he goes, I don't know what happened to me, but I feel like you're my best friend in the world. So, like, what do you got going on right now? Like, what are you guys doing? Because it's you and Matt.
I just really need to come in and go pee, man. Like, I've been on a long ride. I just like a pregnant lady.
Okay.
And there's someone in the other bathroom, and I'm a big guy. Kind of got this complex with having to pee.
You hear me from behind you. You hear from behind me like, Eddie needs to give you a set of keys for the entire building.
He says, oh, you need to... okay, yeah, that's no problem. Here you go. And he hands you like a key ring with all of the keys on it.
Now can I come in and pee?
He says, if you give me 1 second, I'm going to check with the warden. He's in here right now.
Okay.
You're like, no, it's not a good idea. It's not a good idea. You need to come out.
Tell him to step outside and kill himself.
No. You need to come out here and talk to us in the shadows, please.
He's like, oh, okay, yeah, I mean, that's fine. I just got to tell the warden where I'm going.
No, you don't. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. I know him. He says it's cool.
Okay. Yeah, it's fine. Hang on, I have to pull him from another page because I didn't expect him to fucking walk outside.
I guess I will head back over here.
He's like, I didn't expect him to just walk outside.
I mean, like, who the fuck would have seen this coming? Like, alright.
God damn it.
He's over here with you guys. And he goes, and he looks to the left and he sees all the dead bodies. He's like, did you all kill Jerry?
No, they're asleep. No. They're asleep. It's nap time. It's new thing the warden put out. You didn't get the memo.
Okay.
I didn't know. I really like naps. Just, you know, if you see Jerry and Garcia, just tell them they owe me money. We were playing Tonk the other night.
Okay. It's the warden. The warden's in there by himself, right? We're planning a surprise party for him. Is why we brought you out here.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Yeah. Real big surprise party.
Okay. Yeah. I've got the best idea. Let's go round up all the guards.
No. And you're going to come here because I have an even better idea.
Okay.
And I look over at Carlor and I'm like, I give him like, kill him.
No, can't we just have him kill himself? Like, I mean,
is anybody else in there with the warden right now?
No, he's in there by himself. He's actually doing a lot of paperwork right now. So, I mean, we really shouldn't bother him.
I mean, would now be a good time to surprise him? Like, is he in his underwear or is he like, should we wait for him to get dressed? Like, what's he?
No, I mean, the warden is always fully armored. I'm pretty sure he sleeps in it with his great sword. I mean, that's just how he rolls.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Loafiness complex, no big deal.
I still kind of want to see this whole snap on Nick thing. Just throwing it out there.
hey, elf friend, why don't you go ahead and just snap your own neck?
Hey, bud, before you do that, let me ask you, have you done anything in your life that you're not particularly proud of? Like, just something bad.
I kind of, like, give him, like, a magical suggestion to just go ahead and shake his head yes for his sake. For Brian's sake.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. It's really, really bad, yeah.
I've killed a bunch of cats and children.
Okay, so, yeah, for the sake of everyone, I know you've probably been going through some shit. Could you go ahead and just snap your own neck for us? Like, it's cool. I'm one with God. I got you.
Well,
I love this spell. No, this spell's amazing.
I have been having some rough times lately, you know.
Faster.
A little bit faster.
I did. Okay, no, that's no problem, guys. You know, I just want to apologize. Can I atone for my sins real quick?
Yeah, absolutely. Go ahead and get that out of the way.
You're atoned.
Nizan rolls his eyes.
Okay, well, I mean, I just wanted to say that I'm sorry for, you know, eating fish during Lent. I know that's a big no-no, and, you know, that was my bad, and I'm really going to work on that in the future when I'm dead.
Would you say there's anything, like, in the prison that you would need atonement for? Like, I mean, do you do anything that we should know about down there?
Yeah, for sure. There's a bunch of prisoners downstairs. I mean, we just, you know, if we're feeling frisky, we just go right into the cells and beat the ever living shit out of them.
Yeah.
Is there a guy down there with like crazy cracked skin, blue eyes?
We're not supposed to talk about that. But
tell me immediately.
I mean, tell me immediately.
Nazan says it's fine, brother. We're cool, man. We got top clearance here.
It's for God.
It's for God.
Yeah, I mean, he's definitely the prisoner that we're trying to keep secret here. I don't think anyone really knows he's here. Well, the only reason I know he's here is because me and the warden are pretty tight.
I mean, God knows he's here, so he should know what you've done to him as well.
I haven't ever seen him with my own eyes. I just know he's there.
Does the warden have any weak spots or anything?
Sensitive to anything?
I mean, you know, we're making a cake. We don't want to make him sick.
Yeah.
Is he allergic to rope or anything?
No. I mean, he should be fine. You know, if you guys make him a good old cake, I mean, he should be fine.
Okay. Does he have any family we should know about? Like anything?
Who cares?
Who cares?
I mean, I care.
He's pretty high up in the Indergard army, so I mean he's probably got some friends there, you know.
Let me ask, have you ever met Biff?
Yeah.
What do you think about Biff?
Damn it. I mean, he's a good guy.
You think so? Okay.
Yeah, I don't really have a problem with him. I mean, he seems to try and fix all the problems, you know, that the Holy Guard has. I like his name. It's pretty good.
Alright, well, I appreciate your, you know, you've been forgiven, and go ahead and break that neck for us, bud.
Okay, well, it's been nice. I feel like I've grown really close to you guys.
Are we sure we can kill? We can tell people to kill.
Shut up. Voice in the dark.
I read the spell earlier, wondering that it didn't say that.
Shut up.
Right.
We're not doing the math here. We're having a moment.
These guys. Real quick, hang on. Shut up, Celine. These guys are like a fourth of a challenge level, so you guys are just pretty much goobering these guys. So I'm totally cool with this. But we'll basically say that he ends his life for you very quickly, and that's that. So I hope you guys feel really good about yourselves.
I feel great.
Yeah, he's killed cats and shit, man. Like,
yeah, he killed cats and shit. Yeah,
and Justin's trying to influence him in that.
Yeah.
Nice. All right, well, let's see if this warden guy knows anything.
I don't know how accepting he's going to be to.
Well, I mean, he's busy doing paperwork. He might not even look up.
This is true.
That there's like there's fucking five or six of us, man. He's inside of an enclosed stone building. Even if he yells, we're not gonna hear him.
Yeah, just close the door behind you.
Yeah.
All right.
Do I need to reapply a sneak?
I'm gonna give Ben some keys. So he can do what I think he wants to do over there.
Okay. All right, so hang on. All right. So so you guys get in the door. Let me switch. Chop and Abby. So go ahead and drag your dudes in there. Damn, I had like an intricate setup for this and everything. This is all over.
Going to shit.
Sorry.
We all going on the right door?
We're going in the right door? I thought.
So it's like right here, right?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Back here.
Yeah, I'm kind of back here a little bit. Let old Byron go on first.
Yeah.
All right, so you all walk in the door.
I walk in first here.
Okay. Do you want to take first action? What are you doing?
Yeah, I'd like to, clearly the warden's going to see me here.
Yeah.
I'm sure he probably sees us all at this point.
Yeah.
So, hey, man. Little man had to go to the bathroom, so he told me to come in and see if you needed anything. You good over here?
He says, all 45 of you?
Yeah, I mean, yeah. He's really good at what he does, and I'm new. You know, it's a thing. We got to make up for all the good stuff that he did. You know, you guys are bros and all.
Says you're not new. I would absolutely know who you were if you weren't new. What's your name?
Huh? My name's Baron.
Baron.
Belly Hammer, brother!
Last name Biff. Baron Biff. You might know my uncle, Biff.
Biff Biff.
Biff Biff.
So wrong. Roll deception. This story's getting very convoluted.
You can find out why. Biff, biff.
Alright, what is... I think I would know it by now.
D20 plus one.
Look at that. You guys know it. Hup!
Oh god, he's about to decapitate Brian.
The warden stands up out of his chair and grabs his greatsword and shoulders it and turns towards you and looks at you and he says, I know Biff. He's a human and you're a dwarf, so unless some really fucked up interracial sex happens, going to assume that you're not here with Biff or for Biff.
Are we all inside at this point?
What's up?
We all inside at this point? Have we walked all
the way? Yeah, we assume that I closed the door behind me.
Yeah, he has no idea that Ben is there.
Yep.
For right now. So he's like, well, I'll tell you what, I'll make you all a deal because I really don't feel like killing all of you all right now. You just tell me why you're here, we'll figure this whole thing out. What do you guys want? I mean, you're obviously from the Indigard. I don't know who sent you or why they sent you, but just tell me what business you have here.
Okay, so here's the money question. Do I get anything additional for winging a belly hammer?
No, this dude is fully aware of what you're doing.
Okay.
You can even see the handle sticking out from.
Hey, I got a big old belly, all right, and nobody know about the belly hammer. I want them to know about the belly hammer.
Hey, am I still sneaking?
Yeah.
All right. I would like to quietly, while he's distracted looking at the other door, open this door and just get right there, hide.
Okay.
All right,
anybody want to take the lead at this? I don't know what
okay. else to do. All right, Ben. So you got back in there.
I'm gonna tell them that we're here to transport the prisoner to another to Indigard. The cracked skin guy.
What prisoner? The cracked skin guy.
We never knew his name, did we?
We have a special dermatologist over at the other prison. We're just going to have him checked out.
From the CDC. Here to give you a shakedown.
All right, the word's going to tell you. We don't have anyone here that's like that. I don't know what you're talking about.
Can I pull where's old Sean Connery at and be like,
Yeah, where the hell is Sean Connery?
John Mason is sitting outside behind the building. He's not fucking with this at all.
God damn it. I'm beginning to not like this John Mason fellow.
Well, can I roll a like an insight check to see if he's lying?
Like
about not having the prisoner?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. Do you have insight?
Yeah.
Okay, you can absolutely sense that he's probably not telling you the whole truth.
Okay, man. It's like, look, bro, we know he's here. It's real simple. We just want to talk to him.
Okay, look. What happened? Who told you about this?
It's not important. It's actually better if you don't know. But it's really imperative to you're still breathing that we talk to him.
It's actually very important. Because there's only about 6 people in the whole army that know that this person even exists.
You really don't appreciate
you.
If you can't give me a name.
Steve.
Jerry.
Alright. So, the warden's essentially going to just yell enough. And he's basically had enough of you all being dickheads to him. And he's going to take one hand and flip the table over in front of him.
Oh.
Which is going to fly about halfway across the room.
Dang.
So we need everyone standing in the way here to make... actually, he's just going to roll it. And then it's going to go against your deck save. Did that hit anyone?
What do we roll? D20 plus 2?
The deck save? Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, let me do that.
Hit the shit out of me. God damn.
Well, Brian, I don't know if you were in the way. You passed.
Oh, okay.
All right, table hits. Table hits.
Chrisley in the head.
Yeah. That's not how you do that.
So it's going to do 1d4 plus 2. So you take 6 damage and you're knocked prone. We're going to put you like over here.
All right. So hang on. Let me see. Give me... so I'm at 16 out of 22.
Also, everyone needs to roll initiative.
Shit like an initiative.
Oh.
Alright, so Chris is first, I would assume.
Yep.
Brian still has to roll.
What am I rolling for?
I'm initiative.
Sorry. Oh. Yep.
Alright. So it's Chris, Matt, Ben, and then Justin, Warden, and Brian.
Like, I don't understand this fucking PDF viewer that I have. It's a piece of shit.
Alright, so... Chris, you are up first.
Alright, so... I can't get back to my fucking... Give me a second. I'm going to stab myself in the dick.
Alright.
That'll be good. Just give me... Alright, ow. Alright, I'm fine. Okay. Anyway. So... Okay, so I'm not prone. What does that mean?
For this? So you gotta stand up.
Is that a minor action?
We'll say when you stand up, it halves your move speed.
Okay. Well, that's fine. Let's see. All right. So if I stand, I'm just gonna stand up. And then I'm going to. I guess engage, you know, walk up to him and take a swing at him with my rape. Okay. So let's botch this. Okay, I'll take it.
Yeah, you definitely hit him.
Roll 1d8 plus. I get plus. I didn't. But I get plus 2 for my strength, and then I also get. Plus 2 because it's the only thing I'm holding. And I,
okay.
I'm a duelist, essentially.
So minus 7.
Then I would also like to use my. Let's see. What am I? Hang on a second. Actually, no. I'm good for right now, I think.
Okay. Just
fucking wreck my shit.
Alright, so Matt, you're up.
Alright, I'm gonna walk up to him, or engage him, and I'm gonna swing at him.
Alright. Yep, you definitely hit him. Alright, minus 9. So yeah, you definitely swing your sword down, kind of hit him in the arm, in the armor, but the force definitely kind of hits his arm, feels it. Ben, you're up.
Alright, I'm going to use my new cunning action to dash.
Okay.
So I think I can move 2, 3, 2, 3. I believe I can move all the way over to here with dash.
Okay.
And still attack. And I am going to throw a shuriken at him. Give me a sec. Oh no.
Oh god.
Alright, so right about this time,
Old John Mason's getting kind of curious as to what's going on in in the room here. So John Mason. Old John Mason runs in the room. And he has a light crossbow, right? And he says, "You've hurt my friend for the last time, Warden." And he shoots his crossbow, but when he does, he stumbles.
Oh no.
And shoots it at Ben.
Oh Lord.
It doesn't hit Ben, but it goes by his head. Ben gets distracted and just throws his shuriken. The shuriken flies and hits John Mason right in the face and kills him instantly.
Oh my god.
Shit!
My time has come.
Laying on the ground.
Shucker Tash. I've been hit.
He says,
"My bad, guys."
Or tell me he just pulls a Butters when he gets hit. Ben!
Said he falls down and he's laying on his back and he tells you all, "Remember Red October.
Mother Russia will be free."
That's the end of old John Mason. Good job, Ben. Killed a living legend.
That guy really didn't help us do anything anyway.
He did. He stayed outside most of the time. But it's actually better that he's dead.
All right, Justin, you're up. That was eventful.
can I step over John Mason's corpse here? Right. Okay. Jesus.
My favorite thing is imagining everyone else is happening. Like,
yeah. I'm gonna cast Eldritch Blast at the warden, but I'm gonna have Antagonizing Strike with an incantation with it.
Okay, you're gonna have to explain all of that and what's going on.
Well, did I hit him at all?
No.
Okay, then it goes wide. No, all it would do is add an extra like +3 damage to it.
But, okay.
So now it goes wide. So all right, I step back over his corpse.
Okay. All right. Next up is Ye Olde and Warden. And I'll be honest with you guys. I'll look at this real quick. Really makes me sad because I'm fucking retarded. The wrong campaign. All right, so the warden looks at you, Chris.
Nope, don't look at me. Look at this guy.
and he says, "I've been fighting all my life to get ahead of the Dragonborn." And he says, "I'm fucking sick of your people." And he swings his giant ass fucking greatsword at you. Let's see. 17 beat your AC.
My AC was 16, but I also had I can't find it on the fighter. If someone else can find it, that'd be great, because I don't know where the hell it's at. But some of the fighter shit, it was called Defensive Duelist. Mm-hmm. And it basically made it where it's on my character sheet, but I can't find it on my fighter thing. When I'm wielding a finesse weapon with which you're proficient and another creature hits you with a melee attack, you can use to add your proficiency bonus to your AC for that attack, potentially causing the attack to miss you.
Okay. So you would get +2 onto that.
Which would be 18.
Yeah, which you would absolutely beat. So you're good. The problem is he gets to make 2 attacks, so.
Fuck my life. Why does he get 2 attacks? Why is he an asshole?
Because he's like challenge rating 4.
Well, he's a dickwad, so it's fine.
Alright, so gotta roll damage. Take 6 damage.
6 damage, okay. Let's see.
Wait, didn't we get new health?
Yeah, I think everyone's got it done, except for maybe you.
Alright, so let's see. I'm at 10. Okay.
Alright, Billy Hammer.
I don't know what my new health is, but whatever.
I think you're adding 1d10 plus your constitution modifier onto your current health. Or you're adding 10 plus your constitution modifier.
Yeah. So 12. Or I guess whatever your constitution 11. Is.
And so wrong.
BBS motherfucker. Here, I got you. Just worry about what you're doing.
Alright. I'm gonna move up.
Okay.
And give him a old swing of the hammer.
Alright, swing it up. Definitely hit him. Roll that beautiful beam footage.
What is it? A D. Fuck, I forgot what it was. Great hand. Or the great axe. Anybody? Top of the head?
D12.
Plus strength.
Yep.
Believe is 2. It's in D2.
Damn. Okay. Alright, so you definitely hurt him. Bring it down, you hit him in the arm. Just pull it out of him. He's cool with it.
Jesus Christ.
Next up is Chris.
Okay.
Somebody needs to heal Chris when you get a chance.
Well, hang on. I got it. Trying to figure out. Let's see. If I use my breath weapon, is that going to hit Matt? Brian.
Yeah, if it hits like in a cone in front of you, it probably will.
I think it's a one wide cone.
It's like a wide, it's like 5 wide. Or not 5, but yeah, 5 feet or whatever. 30 in front of me.
Oh, well then yeah, you could hit just him with it.
Okay, because we determined last time I could breathe and swing at the same time, right?
Yeah.
Alright, so let's see.
But I think you can only use your breath weapon like once per day or something like that.
Yeah, it's
long rest, I think.
Hang on just a second. Let's see. Use your action. You can use your action to exhale destructive. Your chronic ancestry determines size, shape, damage. Okay. Okay, so I guess not. According to this, it sounds like it's in action. Let's see. Alright, so I do it for 2d6. But I also have I've also got the action surge, which will give me that bonus action. On top of a couple other things. So, okay, here's what I'm going to do. My first action, or my main action, is just going to be to take a stab at him with my rapier again.
Okay.
So let's roll and see if that hits. Did I hit him?
Yes.
Okay. So then I'm going to roll 1d8 plus plus four for a duelist. All right, so I'm going to stab it for 9.
Okay.
I'm going to use my action surge, which is just my second action, to use my weapon. I need to roll to hit that as well. I was going to say the breath weapon just goes in that area, and then he has to save to get away from it.
Right.
So he's either going to take the damage from it or half the damage from it. That's the only two ways he can go.
Yeah.
So I'm pretty sure it's 2d6, I believe.
Okay. So what did you roll to hit with?
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like, it wouldn't be a roll to hit. He would just have to roll to get out of the way, because it's going to hit that area. Regardless. Okay.
What's the DC of it?
The what? The DC. I'm sorry. Hang on. Let me go back and find it. God damn it. This fucking, like, my Adobe Acrobat fucked up, so now I can't, like, look at shit the way I should be able to. I'm using, like, the fucking Google View or whatever, and it's goddamn garbage.
It doesn't matter. Because he doesn't get out of it. He rolled a 4.
Oh.
So it's all good. It's probably like 15 or 14 or something like that.
Yeah, it's, yeah, here it is. The DC for the saving throw equals 8 plus constitution modifier plus your proficiency bonus. So yeah, he wouldn't make it. So it's gonna hit another 2 acid damage. So you did a total of 11.
Okay.
And then the last thing I'm gonna do is it's another once per, not once per day, but once per encounter, once per rest or whatever. Just my second wind.
One D10 plus your fighter level.
Is that what? Okay, thank you.
Yep. And then short or long rest before you can use it again.
So 1d10 plus 2.
Yep.
Okay. All right, so I regain. There we go, 12 hit points. Nice.
Jesus.
So this is going to take me back up to 22. Full health. Look at that, full heal.
Awesome. I'm glad I don't have to heal you. Now I can, own this guy.
There you go. All right. And I'm going to
after Chris went 6 times that turn.
That took probably 6 turns.
I think he's out of all of his...
Yeah, I can't do anything special until we rest again, so...
Well, I mean, Steve's kind of a badass, so... Probably worth it. Alright, man,
Looks like he's using Daedric swords, so, you know, whatever.
Alright, I'm gonna use Inflict Wounds.
Okay.
Which I don't have the fucking stuff with the
okay.
Oh Lord, that's the big one.
Probably gonna have to save against it.
Make a melee spell attack against a creature you can reach. On a hit, target takes 3d10 necrotic damage. Doesn't say anything about a save.
It just says so. It happens.
Range, touch, yeah, make a melee.
Well, it says melee attack, so I'm assuming I have to roll to hit him.
Yeah, you gotta hit him.
And I'm guessing I'm going to put my greatsword modifier on it, or what?
Well, you're...
Like...
You're touching him.
Melee spell attack makes that real confusing.
I'm trying to figure out...
Well, if it's a melee spell attack, it would be just a spell modifier plus the d20.
Yeah, what you got for your spell modifier?
It should be a 3. Hold on.
Okay.
It's wisdom. Yeah, it's 3.
All right, roll it up.
Oof.
Damn, he went off.
You definitely hit him, so roll 3d10 damage, like Jesus Christ.
Yeah, it's
that every turn, or do you have to...
No, it's one of those, you have to have a long rest.
What did it say, 3d10 plus my spell modifier?
No, just
3d10.
Okay.
Don't be greedy, Matt, but 30 potential damage.
Aw, oh, what the hell?
How did you roll 3 4s? That's insane. It just seems really, like, unrealistic.
All right. So, Matt, I guess you're done, right? You're done after you just melted his face off with
cleric necrotic damage?
Yeah, I don't understand it either, but yeah.
You just fucking gave him Jesus disease.
Well, I mean, you basically just, like, yeah, summoned, you know, the power of pain to your fingertips and...
Holy plague. Call it that.
Tickled him with it.
Did leprosy.
Yeah. Alright, Ben, you're back up.
Can you not kill a friend this time?
Friend is a strong word.
Well, okay, how about an acquaintance? Because I'm standing close to you and I'm terrified.
Nope.
Oh.
What the hell, Ben? What are these boxes?
Did you throw in a shuriken again?
Yep.
Okay, well...
I mean, at least he's not trying to hit somebody with a...
I'm going to say, you throw that shuriken at him, and with finesse, he parries the shuriken straight into Matt's chest. So, roll damage.
Look it up again.
I think it's D4 plus.
It's not going to go against my armor. My AC.
No, it just hits you. It's just like, he just flung it off a sword, or just ricocheted into you.
Whoa.
So
Matt takes 6 damage?
No, he takes 8 damage.
Oh.
Ow.
He paired it real good.
Right. He made it do more damage than it probably would have if it would have hit him.
Alright. So Justin's up.
Alright. I am going to cast... What is this thing called? It's my new spell. Arms of Hadar. You invoke the power of Hadar, the Dark Hunger. Tendrils of dark energy erupt from you. Let's see. That creature must make a strength saving throw versus my spell save DC, which is 15.
Okay.
If he fails, he takes 2d6 and can't take actions until his next turn. On a successful save, the creature takes half the damage, but suffers no other effect.
Okay.
So you have to try to make your save.
All right.
Which you do. And so you take half of that, so you take 2.
Okay. You get any other effects?
If it would have hit you, it would have. Wouldn't have been able to do anything this on your upcoming turn, but you dodged it.
Warden's up. He's had enough of Matt's shit. Notice Matt just got hit in the fucking shoulder with a shuriken.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. He's had enough. So he's going to pull his greatsword back and swing it at Matt.
what happens now? Dodge.
It's going to cling off of Matt. And out of the warden's hands. And his greatsword is going to fall away from him, which he goes running after.
And he gets beat up.
And he gets
like an attack of opportunity whenever he runs after it.
All three of you do.
What do we roll for that?
Oh, jeez. Nice.
You guys like my sword?
That's really good. So we'll have Matt roll first. Just all of you all roll d20s to hit him. Just a normal hit.
Wait, we're rolling d20s or d20s?
D20 or...
I get...
Whatever your to-hit dice is with whatever weapon you're holding.
Well...
Okay. So, Matt hits him. Roll that beautiful beam footage.
God damn it, somebody turned my sword into a penis.
Matt hit it fucking hard. Try to hit me, will you, bitch?
Alright. And since he's away from you all, he doesn't get that second attack. You fucked that up pretty good. Brian, you're up.
Well.
How's this dude looking?
As the great belly hammers.
He's like pretty bad. He's like bleeding from his nose and shit right now.
Yeah.
Charging. Great Axe still out.
Mm-hmm.
Swing.
Miss.
Balls.
Chris is up.
Alright, well, I don't know how to Let me get rid of the damn penis here. Anyway, all right, I'm going to move up here.
Mm-hmm.
And just...
Right on top of that dick, huh?
You, How you moving to him?
What do you mean?
You just run in a straight line?
I mean, as straight as I can. Can I run through Matt?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, if I can run through Matt, that's fine. I'll just do that. I mean, either way, I should be fine. I was just going to get around Matt and get up here in front of him.
All right. Well, he gets an attack of opportunity on you.
Why does he get an attack of opportunity?
Because you ran straight.
Because you ran here and then here.
Where was I supposed to run?
Diagonal to him. Like right in front of Matt.
Yeah.
I'm so confused right now.
Like two up from where you're up right now.
Like here. What the fuck is this? Here and then here and here.
I mean, I had to run around Matt. I don't know what the hell I was supposed to do.
What are you talking about?
You're saying you didn't pass through Matt. He ran around Matt and kind of did a diagonal up to where he's at now.
Okay. Yeah, I didn't know I was supposed to. That's what I did originally. Like, I didn't.
If you run through this square one down from you, he gets to hit you.
Yeah.
Even if I'm going at him?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because you can attack him from that one below you, but if you were here, you can attack him, but you ran through Matt through this square to this one, so he can hit you when you go from that one to that one.
Yeah, because you're in range of his attack, and you're just moving. Like, you're not facing him or anything. You're, walking next to him, so he gets an attack of opportunity.
So he's going to hit me with his penis greatsword.
Well, I mean, yeah, essentially. So, hang on. Both attacks hit.
Why does he get to hit me twice?
Because he has two attacks.
He's an asshole. He gets one attack of opportunity. Why does he get two?
Because
I'm sorry.
I'm just being
an asshole. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
All right.
So he hits me twice. That's fine.
That's how much you're going to take. Let's see. So you take 14 damage.
All right. So hang on. Let's see. Yeah, they both hit because 18 is the best I could do anyway.
Wait, what?
Huh? 18. My AC would have been 18. Yeah.
Oh, well, then the first attack doesn't hit you.
Okay.
So hang on.
So would I just take 12 instead?
Take 10.
Okay. Well, now I'm just a little angry. All right, so now this is the attack.
Yep.
All
right.
That is not what I meant to roll. Well, just add a 4 to that.
Plus a dollar sign?
Right, that's supposed to be a 4.
Yes, money!
You hit him.
Okay.
Right on the money.
I'm going to get... Oh man,
buddy!
All right, good for Doug.
All right, so you reach up with your rapier and you stab him in the knee, and as he falls down, you put one arm in the air, like your back arm, like you're fencing, and you essentially just tear his face apart and kill him with your rapier.
Okay.
Dang, you got those dragon claws.
Yeah.
God dang.
So, you guys just straight up killed the warden. No attempt to subdue or talk
to
him.
That's what I was going to do in the next. That's why I asked how bad he was, but didn't get a chance.
So,
his face was ripped off.
Missed opportunity. Alright, so you got the warden dead now. Found out a little bit more information. He admitted that the prisoner is there. So you guys know what you're looking for is at the prison now.
I mean, we got the keys.
Got the keys.
Very nice. Yeah, there's the face that was ripped off.
Yeah.
I start looking around for loot.
Okay. All right, so you notice there's no, you kind of walk around. Y'all walk around the room and look for stuff, and There's not really anything in here, just like useless parchment and shit.
There's no documentation on the prisoner roster or anything?
No.
The hell kind of prison is this?
They're very disorganized.
I mean, there's definitely nothing on the prisoner downstairs. The one prisoner you guys are here for.
So, can I cast Cure Wounds as a ritual while we're doing this?
I don't think you have to ritual it. I think you just cast it.
Yeah, but if I just cast it, then it takes a spell slot for the day.
Yeah, I don't think you can.
And if I do it as a ritual.
I don't think you can ritual it. Rituals require reagents and time.
Okay.
Prep.
Bottles.
Does the warden have anything on him? He had like that crazy sword and armor.
He does. His armor is just plate. I mean, it's his normal plate mail. He does have a +1 greatsword, which a +1 greatsword means that you'll get a +1 to all attacks and all damage rolls when you're using the greatsword for it.
I mean, Matt's the only greatsword user we have, so.
Mm-hmm.
He's got two of them.
Okay, well, he's only got one.
Oh.
He's not a Fury Warrior. That was just the only icon I could find.
Okay.
So you can take the greatsword and add it to you. It's just a greatsword +1.
All right, cool.
He has two spell scrolls on him.
And that's... that's +1 to attacks, not to damage, right?
Right. That, well, actually, it's both. +1 to attack and damage. You've got two spell scrolls on him, so I don't know who wants to take those.
Oh, what are they?
I don't know.
Well, I mean,
throw them in the bag.
If they're useful, I mean, I'd be able to look at them and see what they are, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I mean, I've got a new thing that makes it so I could just see. I can understand all writing. I've got that.
All right. So we'll say, can you just use that whenever?
Yeah, it's just an abjuration. It's just an extra passive I get.
Okay. You notice that both of the spell scrolls are used for the animate dead spell. So
I will take that.
Two of those. Tuck those into your.
Will that armor even fit, Brian?
You should pick up the warden and drag him around and then animate it. Be a badass on your team.
God damn it.
Who said that? Dick Bilby, that's a great idea.
That's true. I now have Reanimate Dead. He's going to be jumping. We can have Bernie's him down there.
Absolutely do that. But here, let's...
It's going to be terrifying. He's just a faceless dude.
Is he going to know anything about, like, is he going to have memories? Can we ask him after we animate him?
I'm pretty sure that they don't.
Yeah, it's just he's just a reanimated corpse. He's just basically a puppet to my will.
He's the mountain now.
See, the spell creates an undead servant. Choose a pile of bones or a corpse of a medium or small creature within range. He's medium, so your spell imbues the target with a foul mimicry of life, raising it as an undead creature. The target becomes a skeleton if you choose bones, or a zombie if you choose a corpse.
All right, how long does it last?
It's creatures under your control for 24 hours.
And then he just falls over dead after that?
No, he stops obeying your commands.
Not gonna reanimate that bastard.
Yeah, we don't have to fucking kill him again. He had a lot of juice in him.
Can Chris wear his armor? Can anybody wear it?
It's plate, so nobody. I don't think anybody has strength yet.
I already have plate armor on, so I don't even need.
So yeah, let's see. Once giving an order, the creature continues to follow it until the task is complete for 24 hours.
Okay, did he turn hostile after that to us?
Yeah. If you issue no commands, the creature only defends itself against hostile creatures.
Well, I mean, we could still animate him and just send him into a room if we need him, like, to kill shit and get killed.
Yeah, I mean, or that after whatever we're doing is done, I could just be like, hey, go walk into the woods and get lost. And he gives a shit what happens to him after that.
We go ahead and fight the guards outside and then get lost.
I mean,
it's up to you all.
I'm just thinking about the guards outside, just see him, the warden, run outside with no face and just start wrecking shit. Now, let me, I have a question. Does he retain his stats from being alive, or does he get new stats for just being a zombie?
Let's see. I'm pretty sure he would retain. The DM has the creature's game statistics, so I'm pretty sure he would just retain what he had before.
Wow, that's a pretty powerful.
But the thing is, he doesn't have his greatsword anymore.
He can have mine.
I mean, either way,
you can get Matt's outside. Old one.
Yeah, the guys outside are pushovers. I mean, fuck.
Okay. So, is that, I mean, but before we do this, let me finish up the loot. Yeah. And we'll figure it out.
Yeah.
So, Justin's got those two scrolls. And then also there is a potion on him as well. It's like a green potion. Kind of bubbles when you shake it up.
Mountain Dew?
I was about to say that. It's fucking Mountain Dew.
Yep.
Can I use
Arcana check? Would that be to know what it is?
Yeah, I can use an Arcana check on it to see if it's anything magical effects. Yeah,
let me do that. Go for it.
I don't know. Alchemy's not my thing.
Yeah.
We got medicine. Can I see if it's anything that'll heal?
Yeah, go for it.
Well,
roll that beautiful bean footage.
All right, you don't know what it is, but you know for a fact it's not a medical potion.
I probably know some shit
kind of acid medicine, bomb or something. Medicine.
Yeah, I probably know stuff about poison, but I don't know how to roll that.
It's an insight check or something, right?
Yeah, we can do that. Just roll. Yeah, that sounds good. Do you want to try an insight check? I can tell you if it's poisonous or not.
My insight, I don't have the actual skill, but it is negative on the little sheet.
Yeah, what's... I don't know the skills in 5th Ed really well.
I'm just going to do what I think.
I mean, is it like saving throws, or not saving throws, but is it where like you just get the bonus? Like you can still do the roll, but you get the bonus.
I mean, it's got acrobatics, animal, arcana, athletics, deception, history, insight, intimidation, investigation, medicine, nature, perception, performance, persuasion.
There. That's my insight roll.
Alright, Matt got a 21 on it.
I mean, does Matt know anything about potions?
I mean, I would assume as a cleric, he knows about like holy stuff, like holy water and shit.
Yeah, you definitely can see it's not holy in any way, shape, or form.
I put it in my pocket.
Yeah, whatever. Just don't fall down. Just don't land on it.
Is it? Hang on. Is it the? You killed John Mason. We won't know if it's the shit from the rock.
Oh Jesus! I hope not. Fucking.
It's a vial of VX gas. Anyway.
All right. Now and he also has 230 gold pieces on him that you all can split.
Shit.
Or not. Fight over it.
I mean, there's five of us, 230 gold pieces. That's, 46
apiece.
Yeah,
let's just split it even. That seems fair.
Sounds like something Ben would say. All right.
I mean,
so,
I promised you guys money on the way, so.
All right, so you guys fell the beast. Because you have accomplished this session, you're gonna level up to level 3 next game.
Oh.
Sweet.
So you guys ready to head back out into the courtyard? I mean, what are we doing here? I mean, this is. We gotta keep playing or what?
Well, I gotta go to bed.
I have a question. Did Brian already give us some gold?
I think he gave us half.
Yeah, he gave you like 4. Also, Nick Milby, I'm sorry we didn't get to you tonight.
That's okay.
I hope you enjoyed yourself, even though.
we'll get you. You're coming in. First act.
I'm all right. It's all good. Thumbs up.
All right.
It's just because they picked the wrong door.
They really did.
Whoever decided on that door is the guy who ruined my night.
You're welcome, Nick Milby.
I have a feeling Ben probably would have stumbled across it. We got to go where Ben wanted to go.
Oh, yeah.